choose my words very, very carefully here. And I want everything I say to really cut through all the establishment propaganda and disinformation. This is probably one of the most profound, important things I've ever said in my 21 years on air. It is completely confirmed that this country has been taken over by foreign multinational corporations who want to pull up the ladder and end the free market system of prosperity and reestablish a form of feudalism. And what's profound about that is it's fact. Not exaggerated, not embellished. We have been hit by 21st century warfare. We have been conquered. But just as profound, the world is awakening. Look at the Brexit. Look at other nationalist movements across the planet, identifying that unelected multinationals through fraudulent trade deals that are actually takeover agreements have seized our nations by fraud and by stealth. But that itself is not the profound statement I was about to make. It's this. In the worldwide resistance to this, Drudge Report, Matt Drudge, Nigel Farage, Alex Jones, Donald Trump are now the undisputed defenders of the nation state. Now, that isn't a statement to sound arrogant or powerful. It's something I don't even want to be in this position. It makes my stomach tie up in knots, and I'm somebody who's never choked on air. We're now approaching a point where it's so surreal, and even the mainstream media admits we're the leaders of the opposition. They act like that's discrediting. No, what it's discrediting of is that people are hungry for freedom and hungry to resist tyranny, and other men have just stood there and done nothing and been bought off and gone along with this. The exciting news is we're having a huge effect. That I never in my wildest imaginations going on air 21 years ago thought that I thought I would raise the alarm and then men who were better than me, smarter than I, more focused with more resources would come to the call to save the country. And instead, listeners supported us and supported others in the movement. And so now the profound statement is without any doubt, everybody looking at it prima facie, on its face, we are the resistance, and that means you are the resistance. You are the power of InfoWars.com. You are the power of DrudgeReport.com. And we are the resistance. Now, that said, everybody's really getting upset right now, and they should. Because Homeland Security is announcing that they're taking over the control of the elections. And that's because we blew their operation wide open a month ago. Everybody knows, again, we launched a move to get Trump to come out and point out election fraud. And Trump took the ball, crossed the goal line big time. In sudden death overtime, and they are in full panic right now. Full panic. They're basically declaring martial law over the internet and infrastructure. That's what they say in this new executive action. This is big. We forced them to move their hand. Okay, things are crystal clear now. In fact, our breakdown and analysis, I would say, was about 98% on target out about 6 months ago on what the globalists would do with our elections. Now we've gotten into completely crisp focus, have a 100% blueprint on what the New World Order is going to do. First off, I want to address a big issue here first. Because I'm just now completely recognizing this because I'm a humble person. And a lot of other people are realizing it, and so is the enemy. InfoWars is at the center of resistance to the world corporate takeover known as the New World Order. We know that. But it is at the absolute center of the zeitgeist. And that means you, the listeners, the viewers, the people that spread the word, the folks that give us the tips, you are the heart, you are the blood, you are the eyes, you are the brain, you are the bones, you're the muscles, you're the feet, you're the hands, you're the fingers, you're the nose, you're the ears, you're the hair, you're everything. You are the InfoWar. What's crazy is no one else thought to launch an InfoWar against the globalists or even call it InfoWar. No one thought to go get the technologies they were using against us in information warfare and turn it around, but load the munitions with truth that's even more powerful. And so it's very humbling. But it's the truth that Drudge Report, it's like fingers on a hand that you form a fist with. Drudge Report, InfoWars, Donald Trump, Ron Paul to a certain extent, helping lay the groundwork, and a constellation of other news organizations and sites, and our military that's very awake. Forms the resistance against the New World Order, and the counter narratives we're putting out against them are so accurate and so truthful, there's no way their system can stand when it's faced with that. The pro-pedophilia publication, Salon, I mean, they are literally push pedophilia, you know, the pedophiles are good people, basically. They're mainlining it. They attack Drudge almost every day, and they say, the Drudge Factor in 2016, providing rumors, scandals, and chatter. The press is all too eager to eat up. And they go on to admit that Drudge is setting the narrative. No, Drudge is setting the narrative of common sense, which everybody else can see. He just has a giant platform to break it down and has the courage to do it. And they can't stand it. That's why George Soros' memos are now public via the latest hack, where he wants UN federally controlled police to shut down the internet for patriots and only let his organization operate. That's word for word. They have to try to shut us down. And it shows really how weak they are, that their entire giant media system worldwide, and the Pope and the Saudi royals and the kitchen sink and the Mexican president and all these other people attacking us, and we're winning the fight for public opinion because we're just promoting common sense. And no matter how much they demonize us, it just bounces off or even makes us stronger. Now that said, there's a reason InfoWars is so successful. And it's because we have a memory and we have common sense. And it's a great responsibility. But when I got up this morning and went to InfoWars.com, then DrudgeReport.com, I instantly knew what I had to do. Come in and play the words of Obama and Jay Johnson and others to show you how they're deceiving you. Ladies and gentlemen, Homeland Security is announcing that it is moving to completely take over the elections. And guess who's going to have Homeland Security authority in the elections? Guess. The multinational body that founded the United Nations and that basically controls the security agreements in the European Union. The security directive of the OECD. That is the technical name of the reorganization project that took place after World War II, known as the Marshall Plan. This is when you get down to the bottom layer of what actually runs things, the foreign global multinational system is coming in to run our elections. Now, before they let the Associated Press and five other trusted establishment media groups announce the fake numbers whenever they stole elections, because we've called it and Trump's called it and we've talked about it, they are being forced now to openly call an infrastructure protection, which Homeland Security always said they would do. I told you 15 years ago when they first gave it cabinet-level status that Homeland Security was going to openly basically make law by regulations, and you'd have to have approval from them to build a barn in your backyard, have a farm, have a job. How did I know that? I watched the C-SPAN hearings when they were founding Homeland Security. I watched what Governor Ridge said they were going to do. And they are now going to run our elections. Now, remember, Obama said, Alex Jones, you know, Donald Trump, you know, well, back then they wouldn't say my name, the Texan, the creature in Texas, says that media. The feds aren't involved in elections. Locals run it. Oh, really? The feds aren't involved in elections. They always were telling the media what returns to put out, trying to steal elections. Sometimes they weren't successful. Now they're coming in with the UN. That's what this is, to run it. And I covered this in great detail last week from Reuters. Reuters. OSCE. That's the security agreement of the OECD. Rights group. Oh, it's a rights group, just like all Soros' groups are, request 500 international observers to monitor the U.S. presidential vote, 10 times what they did in 2012. And now this, from WorldNet Daily, Washington Examiner, it's on DrudgeReport.com, it's all been announced openly. Homeland I's special declaration to take charge of elections, Jay Johnson, the Department of Homeland Security began considering declaring the election a critical infrastructure, which means they're over it, and law is suspended under executive orders. We're going to cover all of this in great detail. And we told you it was coming. The internet's handed over October 1st to the UN. Fox News has been coup d'etat internally, so they won't challenge fraudulent returns. You see them moving, folks. This is the big one. Trump is way ahead in many polls, neck and neck, even in their fake polls, LA Times polls, he's ahead. They know he's the next president. They're going to try to block it. This is bigger than 1776 because there's 7.5 billion people. We've been overrun by globalists. There's all these weapon systems. The globalists are starting wars with Russia right now. This is an over-the-top moment never before seen in history. And I'm sitting here with chills up and down my spine because I have the detailed analysis and breakdown. And I wrote reports. I'm just going to stop right there. I told you I had to take off some time over a month ago and write reports for people. I wrote reports on what I believe they would do. And I got it to the right people, obviously. And I'm telling you exactly what I said is happening. And I'm like doing the work nobody else will do. And I'm not even bragging. But I'm telling you, at this point, folks, when it comes to strategy against these people, I mean, I'm right there at the top, and I'm just like, this is insane that there aren't other men out there that were fighting this. There's this Drudge and Joseph Farah and you know, Donald Trump's got the will to do it. God bless him. Incredible stamina and courage. But I'm just letting you know, the listeners, how important you are and how historic this broadcast is, so you understand. Because we're going to do what other people aren't going to do. Common sense. We're going to play Jay Johnson first. This is what Homeland Security Director says about Trump, and he's going to run the election. I'm going to skip this break. This is so beyond bombshell. This is hydrogen bomb level over the top. He's come out and said you're disqualified. Obama said you're disqualified. You're not allowed to run. You're evil. You're bad. You're un-American. Everything they are. And then they're going to run the election with the corporate group that did the reconstruction of Europe, that's funded and run by the Rothschilds, Rockefellers, and the globalists, a private combine. I mean, this is the shadow world government. The Organization of Economic and Cooperative Development is the new world order. It's the IMF, it's the World Bank, it's the WTO, it's the TPP, it's the tentacles, it's the group, it's totally secret. It's dispatching its security services, that's Interpol and spooks, to run our election. It's beyond the UN. The UN is just its little fact totem that it transfers sovereignty to and then it runs, but it's still a front and a fake debating club. This is unbelievable, but I predicted it. You know, I predicted it months ago on air. I know the enemy. I know their operations. This is all I do is study them. And I'm not bragging. I'm saying you need to know you are getting the Death Star plans, period. This is it. And the thing is coming around and is going to be clear to fire in the next few months. Total world government tyranny is coming in. They're planning a financial collapse after this. That's evident. They're trying to prop up the German banks. They admit they're preparing martial law, troops in the streets. Germans are already getting the food off the shelves. I mean, you can just see it. Tick, 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 tick. They're just running the jihadis in as fast as they can. Oh, my God, help us. And I don't mean that in vain. I mean, God help us. This is incredible. I'm sure now they're making their big move. This is it, folks. They're going to start wars. They're going to plunge stock markets. They're going to turn paramilitary loose. You decide what side you're on with God right now. The photo on drudgereport.com says it all. It's behind me on screen. Maybe we can pull back and show folks. Them in their big fake Homeland Security Situation Room where they spy on everybody and all the rest of it. And they're going to run the election. Of course, they were always doing it, but Obama said they weren't. So let's play Jay Johnson. This clip is, talk about projection. This is it. I believe this, that, this is Jay Johnson just a few months ago. I believe that it's the responsibility of those of us in national security and Homeland Security. When a leading candidate for office proposes something that is irresponsible, probably illegal, unconstitutional, and contrary to international law, un-American, and will actually hurt our efforts at Homeland Security and national security, we have to speak out. And he went on to say Donald Trump is disqualified and shouldn't be president. They're the ones doing all this. They're the ones violating our laws. They're the ones opening our borders. They're the ones involved in all these scams. They're the ones, and now everything they say about us is what they're doing. And they're going to run the election. But remember, going at Roger Stone on the line, remember, Obama said that the feds aren't involved in elections. He said, what is election fraud? Ha ha, like it doesn't even exist. This is the complete arrogance of these people. Look, I know you can fix the elections. I know you can get away with basically any crime you want. I get all of that. But you can't go on forever, globalist. You're doing it in front of everyone now. And just because you're planning to try to shut down the internet and have some type of civil emergency to cover your butt, it's not going to work. You people are crazy. And just because you've been put in by the New World Order because you got chips on your shoulders or whatever, just because you call people that want free elections racist doesn't make it so, Obama. And you're not allowed to steal elections, Obama, for Hillary, just because you're part African. The political correctness is over. Let's go ahead and play Jay Johnson. This is the guy who is absolutely should recuse himself. He is disqualified. It's a conflict of interest, the most brazen of which we haven't seen in a few months since Loretta Lynch was meeting with Bill Clinton illegally on the airplane. So here's Jay Johnson.
As the Secretary of Homeland Security, I have avoided responding to the political season and what candidates have said running for president. However, I believe that it's the responsibility of those of us in national security and homeland security when a leading candidate for office proposes something that is irresponsible, probably illegal, unconstitutional, and contrary to international law, un-American, and will actually hurt our efforts at homeland security and national security. We have to speak out.
And that's Trump wanting to vet Muslims coming in. Oh, if you're not checking their IDs, then stop them. Well, I can't get in without them checking my passport. Now, this is the guy that's going to run the elections. And I told you they're going to try to steal the election because Trump, in so many real polls and scientific polls, is really ahead. They know this. And I told the world, watch. They're involved. They stole it from Sanders. They tried to steal it from Trump. And Trump has common sense. He comes out. He's done his own research. He says exactly that. And they flip out and say, Trump's a kook. We're now going to have the UN and the EU overseeing our election. That's Reuters. And guess who advises them? Soros. We have his own emails. So here is the clip from Obama making fun of myself and Trump, saying election fraud, what's that? And saying the feds aren't involved. As they move to, quote, take over the election, to take charge of critical infrastructure. That's called martial law when the party in power takes control of the election. This is, but don't worry, the UN's here to certify it's okay. They admit they're watching Trump and making sure he doesn't try to stop illegals from voting. This is a foreign takeover of America. This is treason emboldened, emblazoned in flame. You are watching history, people. Let's play the clip of Obama.
Of course the elections will not be rigged. What does that mean? The federal government doesn't run the election process. States and cities and communities all across the country, they're the ones who set up the voting systems and the voting booths. And if Mr. Trump is suggesting that there is a conspiracy theory that is being propagated across the country, including in places like Texas, where typically it's not Democrats who are in charge of voting booths, that's ridiculous. That doesn't make any sense.
And he implies we're saying Texas will be stolen. We're talking about nationally, the feds involved. Homeland Security's always been involved the last 15 years. Now they've got 10 times the monitors. They're bringing in foreigners to come do their dirty work. This is like a spy novel on PCP. It's happening. It's in Reuters. They're seizing control. And I tell you what I think Trump has to do right now. We're going to do it. We're going to put together the informational videos. You can call them ads, but they're not. They're just support of the First Amendment and the right to vote, where we show Obama saying feds don't run elections and then cut to them announcing that the feds are taking over the elections. And then Trump warning of this and being proven right. I mean, the UN and the EU bureaucrats are going to be here running our elections. Roger Stone, at this point, this is so incredible that this is actually happening. This appears like they're completely panicking. They seem completely wild-eyed and desperate. I've never seen such lies. I've never seen such cheerleading in the media for other media to get more intense in lying. Trump is acting presidential, going to New Orleans, going to Louisiana, going to Mexico today to meet with the Mexican president. What in the world is going on here? How can the party in power announce an emergency and seize control of the election, which we already know they were trying to mess with? Sir, what are the words to describe this?
Sure. Well, first of all, let's address, Alex, what the president said. We don't even know what election theft is, what voter fraud is. Let me illuminate the president. It is manipulation of the computerized voter machines in wide use in this country, the so-called Diebold or PES machine. We have an authoritative Stanford study that shows that these machines were rigged against Bernie Sanders. We have a study by a Princeton professor, Appel, showing that the machines can be rigged in 7 minutes or less. We have a CBS video showing how a $15 device you can buy at Radio Shack or Best Buys can be used to hack these machines and vote multiple times. CBS, not exactly a part of the conservative alt media. So the president is saying, in essence, he ignores the technology, and we're supposed to rely on the integrity of those in the political process not to rig the election, even though it is technologically very possible. Here's what's happened, Alex. Donald Trump has raised this question, and more Americans are asking whether we're going to have an honest election. This is the establishment's attempt to put a cap on this. I reminded of Ronald Reagan, who said the most dangerous words in the English language, "I'm from the government and I'm here to help you." You're right, there is no significant role. We need to watch the watchers, because that's where this election...
And you said that over a month ago. You said, Alex, I'm more concerned about Homeland Security. You said Loretta Lynch and Jay Johnson on this show. We got to find the clip because it's so powerful, and show the date, because it's just, this is this... We are so on target. I'm not even bragging. I just can't believe how on target Drudge is, Trump is, you are, we are. I mean, we are on target. That's why they're crapping their pants.
Right. And I think your listeners need to get acclimated. Anytime a speaker or an analyst or somebody in the news or someone who supports Hillary says the words conspiracy theorist or conspiracy theory, that person is lying. Whatever they're telling you is a lie. You see, they can't refute that these machines are hackable. They can't refute that they've been hacked in the past.
And they say Donald Trump's disqualified. He's not allowed to be president. The guy running the machines is saying this to us, that just let Hillary off. Stay there, sir. You're going to have the floor when we come back. Ladies and gentlemen, he has a lot of the breaking news, but this is just incredible that this early. I knew Homeland Security was going to be involved doing it. But now they're just like, we have to protect it from hackers. The Russians want to steal it. If Trump wins, the Putin did it. Oh, and let's not forget, I said who's leading the resistance against the New World Order. Front and center, it is Vladimir Putin. Because he's a nationalist, folks. He's not in our business. We'll be back. Stay with us. So get ready for the propaganda. You're going to see it tonight on the news. Because it's put out by the White House, regurgitated by Media Matters, and then loaded into the teleprompters from CNN to MSNBC to ABC to NBC. The Russians are going to steal the election with hackers. They've already started planting these fake seeds. But Homeland Security is going to go in there and save us from it by sitting over the tabulation. Oh, and by the way, we're going to use spooks from the most secretive organization there basically is. This is Reuters reporting this. The OSCE, the Security Services Directive Agreement of the Marshall Plan. Let me tell you what the Marshall Plan was. Stuff like putting 1 million Germans in a concentration camp and letting them starve to death. I mean, it was hardcore martial law in Germany and other areas for many years. This is the actual guts of the shadow robber baron world government. And here's Reuters. 500 monitors, 10 times what they had in 2012, with Justice Department power. And I have mainstream news saying the UN to run our police now. Here's this. Obama administration and UN announced global police force to fight extremism, wait for it, in the U.S. They're looking at starting a civil war, boys and girls. The entire setup's there. And I know I've been harping on this forever, but this is really happening. I'm going to go to Roger Stone here because, again, he's the guy that got Donald Trump over the years, really pushed him to run. Donald, of course, did it himself, former head of his campaign. He knows the mind of Donald Trump. But now it's so clear that Donald Trump is a patriot, is a champion, is a nationalist, and the whole global crime syndicate is doing everything they can to stop him. U.S. News and World Report has articles out about what happens if he dies. Then the election's canceled. Very creepy stuff. They are telegraphing threats. This is an over-the-top time to be alive. And just finishing up here, Jay Johnson says, I'm going to disqualify Trump. And now he says, I'm going to run the election. And Obama says, there's no such thing as election fraud. What's that? Besides, the feds don't run elections. As he comes in with executive action, Infowars.com, Washington Examiner, WorldNet Daily, Breitbart, but it's all directly linked to them. Homeland I's special declaration to take charge of elections. And now you see the internet being censored. You now see patriots being censored. You now see leaked memos reveal Soros' plan for federally controlled police themselves directed by the UN. And libertarian and patriot conservative sites not allowed to operate in the web of the future. Kicking us off the web, putting us into non-electronic gulags. Going to Roger Stone, I want to talk about how we stop this, what we do. For me, Roger, this signifies very, very serious desperation. Even their tweaked polls in the LA Times show him a point or more ahead. A lot of the algorithms, as you know, show him winning handily. I know you like to be a pessimist just to be safe, but am I wrong in saying they're panicking right now? And doesn't this backfire when they all say you're disqualified, you can't be president, and then they come in after Donald and others, as I said earlier, we needed to raise this early before they came in and took it over. We raised it. Now they come in. This looks like they've really stepped in it, Mr. Stone. Give us your expert analysis.
Sure, Alex. What all of this means to me is that they have every intention of trying to rig this election, and they're now trying to put the best possible face on it, dress it up. I think Trump has signaled them very strongly that if he is robbed, he does not intend to walk away. If there is hard core admissible evidence of a rigged election, that he's going to dispute the election. So they're trying to dress up the results.
And you are building an army, and we are building an army to have exit polls and analysis, they know we're serious.
Interestingly enough, the only hacking that's going on is the hacking of us. Yesterday, Senate Majority Leader Harry Brown wrote to the FBI demanding that they investigate me and the Russians, which is laughable.
Told you that was coming.
Regarding whether we have obtained certain Democratic Party documents through hacking. Let's be clear. There is no evidence that the Russians have hacked anyone yet. The DNC documents that indicted Deborah Wasserman Schultz and showed that Hillary stole the nomination from Bernie came from Crucifer 2 in the original hacking and then were authenticated by WikiLeaks. No Russian involvement.
And Guccifer 1 was not Russian. Look, we've now, it's been confirmed that it's actually U.S. intelligence agencies actively doing this because they know there's a foreign takeover of the country. And this is amazing. I mean, this is incredible.
Yeah, an extraordinary piece in the Financial Times yesterday documenting the involvement of Ukrainian billionaire Viktor Pinchuk, his ties to the Clinton campaign, and the fraudulent campaign used to smear Paul Manafort. The ledger that alleges payments to Manafort, a forgery by Ukrainian intelligence. Yes, there's foreign interference in our elections, but it's not by the Russians. It's by the paid allies like Soros, like the Ukrainians.
Sure, that's a Soros operation. Ukraine is their new headquarters. They've taken it over. They're stealing the gas, stealing the money, stealing the bonds, looting everything. And what did Soros say? He goes, I want to take over Ukraine to get a new Marshall Plan that'll fund my operations. He doesn't even hide it. He bankrupts it. He gets the new Marshall Plan and then takes over.
And really what's extraordinary here is the chutzpah of the Clinton people saying Trump is in bed with Putin when it's the Clintons who sold Putin control of our uranium production. It's the Clintons who have done favors for the oligarchs who are supporting.
And by the way, even the Huffington Post is reporting this. It's strange they're even telling the truth. I mean, Hillary gets $35 million from the Russians to get one-fifth our uranium. That's treason. Can you imagine if Trump did something like this?
Well, what's amazing here is that your activities, my activities, the folks at StopTheSteal.org, the folks who watch InfoWars, the watchers of Breitbart and Daily Caller and so on, we are under their skin. They attacked you by name last week, the Democratic candidate for president. They attacked me the week before, saying that I am a right-wing conspiracy theorist. No, I'm a conspiracy realist. I deal in facts. And the fact is, they are prepared to steal this election. They are prepared to rig these machines. The Clinton Foundation is a slush fund, and more precisely, a vehicle for the facilitation of multi-billion dollar bribes in which everything in our foreign policy was essentially for sale. So to the extent that there's foreign interference in our elections, it is by Viktor Pinchuk and
absolutely, and it's admitted. So let's stop right there. This isn't tooting our horn. It's letting the listeners understand this and know this. Infowars.com, Alex Jones, Matt Drudge, DrudgeReport.com, a constellation of other groups who deserve credit as well, WorldNet Daily, Daily Caller, Breitbart in a big way. They always try to demonize us and act like we're discredited because they're actually so scared of our narrative because it's actually historical and accurate and what CENTCOM knows is true and what generals all over the place like Flynn and others know. I mean, the entire military basically now knows there's a foreign takeover. They get it. They are linking up. They're aware of what's happening. And I really think that the folks up top who've stolen the country are starting to realize how much trouble they're actually in and how many crimes they've actually committed as more emails come out that Hillary wasn't just selling access to the president through her foundation, but to the Chinese president. That is a whole nother level of insanity. I mean, these people are crazy. Look at how she kept stuff on her private server, knowing it would be hacked. I mean, it does seem like they're incredibly reckless, Roger Stone. What do you make of their position right now and the fact that they tried to demonize you and I and Drudge and others? Trump took all these messages and truth and his own ideas, busted through it all, and now they're in panic mode because everything we've said has been legitimized. the extremists are now the gold standard. We're not the extremists. We're what's left of America. We understand what's happening. So all I'm letting the listeners know is this is the brain trust. Why are they panicking so much? Where do we go next, Roger Stone?
Well, notice the entire campaign of personal vituperation, personal attacks. You see, when they can't refute your arguments, and they're worried that you're starting to communicate the truth about how they intend to steal this election and about how the mainstream media is entirely one-sided, you get attacked personally. They've attacked you. They've attacked me. They attack Stephen K. Bannon, manufacturing.
They're doing incredibly dirty things behind the scenes right now, folks, just so you know.
And it's all personal. One of my very close associates, Christian Josie, longtime conservative activist, hacked as soon as he came to work for me. His email, his bank accounts, his social media contacts. All he did was go online and tell the truth. Bill Clinton is a serial sexual predator, and Hillary has acted as an accessory.
So they're bullying. It's not working. What do they do next? How do these slime bags, these cornered rats, what do they do next?
Well, I think it's very clear. They're going to continue the war of personal attacks. They're going to try to make Donald Trump into Barry Goldwater, 1964. He's mentally unstable. He's unfit.
You predicted that. Now the main drum is he's mentally ill, when Hillary obviously is mentally ill.
Yeah, it's very clear that that anything they say about Trump turns out, ironically, to be true about their own candidate. Folks will be able to get Trump's measure in these debates. They'll be able to see whether or not he is capable of the big job. He's been very disciplined on the campaign trail. He's been on offense. She's on defense. The polls are closing quickly nationally. There's a little lag in the key states, but the whole point here is this is a viable race. The media is going to be telling us now for the next 60 days, it's over, Trump's a loser, it's going to be a landslide. They're trying to set an expectation level for the subsequent rigging of the elections. Read the Stanford study, read the Princeton study, read the study by Professor Robert Fetrakis at Ohio State Community College. These are learned men. These are not right-wing kooks. They will all tell you how easy it is to rig these machines.
Sure. Roger, I understand you do probably 20 interviews a day. I mean, you're killing yourself. You're amazing. And you're educating our audience. But our audience is extremely educated in all this. We're talking strategy here with you, my friend, with the actual soldiers, the sergeants, the captains, the colonels, the generals. And in so many cases, I mean literal generals, as you know, that understand, we understand, they understand, we're on target. You know, this is real analysis, real info. We're sitting here in a big, basically war encampment around the big table in the tent. Strategy, our strategy, the enemy strategy. We don't have to hide our strategy. We wear it on our shoulder, you know, tell the truth. But I mean, do you agree with me that the enemy is floundering right now and really making desperate moves, revealing their open plan to bring in multinationals to oversee the election with the Justice Department and the Homeland Security that say they're not going to let Trump be president? This is so naked. Let's talk about that. And then what do we do if they do try to steal it in the battleground states?
Well, I think this has several parts, Alex. First of all, they are going to have the full force and budget of the federal government to try to pull off this ruse. As I said, we have to watch the watchers.
So that's the real announcement. Homeland Security, run by foreign multinationals, is announcing they're going to steal the election. I mean, that's all this is. They're now announcing they're going to come in and steal it.
And I've now determined that the data center to count all the votes nationally is based in Spain. In Spain, not in the United States.
Of course.
There is going to be an ongoing effort to create an expectation level so that they can pull off the steal more smoothly. The campaign of personal attack and vituperation is going to continue. It's not going to matter, Alex. I'm not running for president. You're not running for president. She is running.
Look, it's an honor to be lied about, attacked by total scum.
But let's be clear. George Soros is giving the traitor, misfit, David Brock, a man who would make Joseph Goebbels proud when it turns to lies and disinformation, $30 million to go on Twitter, to go on Facebook, to spread disinformation about us personally, but about this election, about the Clinton Foundation, and so on. We have to rely on volunteers. That's why I beseech patriots, Go to stopthesteal.org. We need you to volunteer.
Trump is building an army. We're building an army. And let's be clear, folks. We're not bragging. We want you to understand this is the equivalent of the X-Wings going down the trench towards the Death Star. This is history. This is for all the marbles. This is at the highest levels. We are engaging them. I haven't even plugged this hour. Everyone must go to InfoWarsStore.com and get a Hillary for President shirt at cost, $9.95. That includes shipping. Everyone must go there and get a Bill Clinton rape shirt for $19.95. That helps fund our operation, helps fund Roger right in the nose spending his own money. We are totally committed, folks. I am ready to go through whatever I have to, okay? And they've threatened me well. Don't worry. I am 110% committed. I've never had private security. I got it right now, okay? That's the level. In fact, we can show Twitter one of the security guys. He actually runs a large security company and works for one of the top former generals. But I'm going to stop right there. Just understand, ladies and gentlemen, that you can go to my Twitter and show folks a cue. This is what we're dealing with. This is real. This isn't going and seeing the movie The Godfather where the mafia is doing stuff. This is real. This is multinationals conquering the country. We need your financial support. You need Selenium. We have the best bioavailable form, super low price, $19.95. Nobody's got this. This should be $50, okay? Totally organic. Most stuff synthetic. You need to get the Super Male Vitality. You need to get the Vitamin Mineral Fusion, 20% off. You need to get Super Male Vitality. You need to get Lung Cleanse. You need to get the bone and joint formulas. You need to go and get Strategic Relocation. You need to buy the videos. You need to support us. You need to send the links out. You need to spread the word. You need to go to Stone Zone. You need to go to Stone Cold Truth. He's got a new website. You need to understand this is a total war, StoneColdTruth.com. This is a total commitment. You want to be an American? You want to fight the New World Order? You want somebody to march on Washington? We're marching with Donald Trump. We marched in Cleveland. We marched in Philadelphia. We're battling in the streets, communists spitting and hitting us and saying we should die. We are, and I'm not bitching. I want this fight. I love it. The point is that we're committed. We're doing everything we can peacefully. We're going through hell, and I love it because this is the animating contest for liberty. But I'm just saying, we need you to realize you are the guts and the heart and the blood of this operation and the brains and the eyes and the soul and the will. And so I want our coffers against these enemies because I can tell. I mean, it's a lot of crap going on. I mean, they are really serious. We're fighting hardcore mafias, okay, that brag about 500,000 kids dying, you know, under the Clintons in Iraq being a good price to pay. These are demons that no one's ever called. We're calling them. We know who they are. We've built the platforms to fight them. We are fighting them. We need you to support us. Get Stone's books at InfoWarsStore.com. Get them on his website. Spread them. But you understand, this is war bonds. This is 21st century war, and we are soldiers on the front lines. Roger.
Yeah, we need hardcore volunteers. If you can't help us in the exit polls, if you can't be a poll watcher, send us $25. Send us $50. Help fund the operation, because when this election is
over... Wars aren't cheap, people!
It's not enough to say we were robbed with no evidence. But if there is admissible evidence that this election was stolen... then there will be widespread civil disobedience in the
run-up. That's right. These bastards know we're not going down, and Trump's not going down. Stay there, Roger. This is epic. Roger Stone's our guest. One final segment with him. Then we've got a lot of other guests joining us in analysis. But if you just tuned in, I'll recap the huge news. Homeland Security, basically under civil emergency, is going to take over the election. Obama said they're not involved, though. Whoa. Donald Trump at 2:30 today is going to be meeting with the Mexican president, Central, and flying up to Arizona. The guy is a war machine against tyranny. The stamina, just totally presidential. And they look at this guy that doesn't drink, doesn't smoke, exercises, fuels himself on red meat, pure Americana, and they just are pulling their hair out. Roger Stone is our guest. I cannot stress enough, now is the time to spread the word. The world is listening. How obvious is it with Obama saying there's no such thing as election fraud, the feds aren't involved, and then the feds announced basically a civil emergency over critical infrastructure to protect the election and are coming in to take it over because they're worried about hackers when they're the ones, the federal government and others, that have been caught stealing elections. We've had Diebold chief engineers testify to Congress on this. So just what Roger Stone, so astute, listen to him. He said a month ago on this show repeatedly, watch the watchers, watch Homeland Security, watch Jay Johnson, Loretta Lynch, watch if they send a bunch of people in, that's who'll steal it. And now they want to protect it all of a sudden. And that shows they're making this risky move because they know Trump is pulling ahead. 5 minutes left. Thank you for your time, Roger Stone. Other points you'd like to add?
Yeah, I think we're at a crucial juncture here in which they're trying to set the narrative in advance so that they can get away with stealing this election. Look, you have a number of events that are going to roil this race. I am absolutely convinced that Julian Assange and the folks at WikiLeaks have the equivalent of political dynamite that they intend to drop on the Clintons between now and the election. So now suddenly David Brock, Media Matters for America, Correct the Record, which should be Distort the Record. Now suddenly we're questioning the credibility of Assange. He's a conspiracy theorist. He's a nut, even though
these are admitted documents that prove Hillary is commanding the media.
Right. So where the documents came from is really immaterial. It's what the documents say, because none of these leaks have ever been questioned in terms of their authenticity.
Well, even real liberals like Greenwald are coming out and saying Hillary's a complete monster, because she is.
These emails are the equivalent of the Watergate tapes. They're indelible. They're out there, and they're going to come
back. They're worse. They're worse. They're more powerful.
In the ass.
They're more powerful. What do they do then when these come out? Start a new war? I mean, how are they going to try to distract from all this, Roger?
Well, first of all, their friends in the mainstream media will attempt to minimize it. You can already see the drumbeat now questioning the
motive. It's Russians.
Right. It's Assange. He's releasing the truth to help the Russians. I want to know what the truth is. I mean, Putin's not a dumb man. He understands that Hillary's word is no good. He knows that Hillary is a liar. He knows that no negotiation he
Hillary
has.
Hillary loves failed states and is evil.
And he knows that Trump is for a period of detente. Trump wants peace. Trump is the peace candidate.
And that's horrible. So they say he wants nuclear war. He wants peace, so he wants nuclear war. She wants war, so she's good.
And he frankly would like to have a period of hard-headed negotiations after which we could coordinate our activities with the Russians.
Exactly. And he knows China is the one screwing us over, not the Russians.
Well, like Nixon, he's prepared to play them off against each other in the best interests of the United States, as opposed to the Obama-Clinton foreign policy, which is bending over for them.
Getting back to Trump and his view on Russia, I mean, you're saying, obviously, from just your research, obviously not from talking to him, that he would like to work with Russia. That would be great. Imagine a world, the globalists for 100 years, the robber barons have always tried to stop us from linking up with Russia. Doesn't that make perfect sense?
Well, look, economic opportunity is what got them out of the gulag, and capitalism works. That's why they have to use it to reform their system. Putin is a nationalist. Trump is a nationalist.
Hold on, 70 seconds. I know you have another interview, but do five more with us and we'll let you go. Roger Stone's our guest. I'm Alex Jones. The feds are announcing, well, Obama's announcing he's taking control of the election. He's taking control of the election. Obama. The same people that no-billed Hillary. This is unbelievable. This is the craziest thing I've ever seen. For a corporate eugenics-based world government to ever take control, it would have to do so by stealth. Their own Banff Canada 2007 documents say by stealth, we must keep this secret. With world leaders meeting with corporate leaders. You can't put that genie back in the bottle. And if you're receiving this transmission, you are the resistance. I've said for decades here, I know they're ridiculing me and attacking me, but I know when their plans start going into place, my credibility will explode. But that isn't what matters. The time bombs were already planted politically. A lot of them. And so you can't even kill the messenger at this point. Going back to Roger Stone, how do they set up the world government, the UN takeover of the internet next month, George Soros saying only his groups will be able to be on the web, all this megalomania of these narcissists and borderline personality disorders and sociopaths and psychopaths? I mean, look, there were a lot smarter crazies like Hitler and Napoleon that got their butts kicked. I really smell defeat and almost death on these people. I just hope they don't take us all with them. But what about, in closing, and then any other final points, Roger Stone of StoneColdTruth.com? I just think history's against them is what I'm saying.
Well, this explains the uptick in the bully boy tactics. I mean, three people who worked for me have now been hacked. These same three people tell me that they believe they're under around-the-clock surveillance, a dark car with smoked windows outside their homes. These are just IT people. The death threats have ticked up sharply. I got a nice email this morning. He said, the Clintons have killed many people who get in their way. You are next. Very nice. Very heartwarming.
Yeah, well, they don't send the black cars around anymore because a few times, you know, things happen. But
well, you live in an open carry state. I do not. But the point here,
somebody pulls on the black car. I mean, I go over and start talking to him. But yeah, go ahead.
The greatest single mistake of those who are running the country and indeed the world was when they allowed the legalization and the widespread of the internet. We have found each other. We are together. We're in touch. Now, when they talk about regulating the internet, that means shutting it down. That means censoring
His own email says he wants to shut us down, Stone.
Too late. Too late. We know how to find each other, and we're ready to march. The toothpaste cannot be put back in the tube.
So what do they do? Hopefully they back off and are smart, but they're not going to. What do we do when they try to steal the election? We should do a whole show on this.
If they steal this election, Alex, I predict to you they will not be able to hold on to it.
I agree.
They are going to cause a constitutional crisis.
And by the way, you were the number two in command taking it away. I mean, who knows who really won from Gore. I mean, you're somebody that does this.
Well, in that case, we don't really know who won that election. It's actually impossible to decipher. And therefore, a war of tactics and superior strategy awarded that election to George W. Bush.
And that's why they're so scared of you.
Well, the fact that he then led us into the Iraq War is one of the
greatest. No, I know you hate him and you've gone public ever since then. I mean, you're for marijuana legalization. You're more of a libertarian. I mean, you're a good guy.
Look, I'm still asking my God for forgiveness for what I've done for the Bushes. I was blind, but the scales.
And look at how they're in bed with the Clintons. So you're really battling the Bushes now. You're trying to get your soul back.
Well, right, because it's the same criminal combine. This is the Bush-Clinton crime family. Read my books.
No, I agree with you, and you don't say that. I'm telling you thing about Roger Stone when I love him. I mean, this is a great guy because he is so accurate. He doesn't tell you what you want to hear. He really tells you what he really thinks is going on. And nine times out of, you know, I mean, it's just, I'd say nine times out of 100, he's dead on. I agree with you. They're not going to, if they steal this, it's their undoing. They will not be able to keep it in their hands.
Agreed. Alex, we'll see you next week.
Absolutely. Or anytime you want to pop in, Roger Stone, anytime. StoneColdTruth.com. Get his books at InfoWarsStore.com and get the Bill Clinton rape shirt he designed at InfoWarsStore.com as well. Thank you so much, Roger.
Great to be here.
Yeah, if you're going to punch the Clintons in the nose politically, why not go all the way? And we've done that here. We are all in 100% commitment. The human spirit is being reignited. What an unbelievable interview yesterday with Nigel Farage. One blind spot we have here at InfoWars is we'll have huge breaking news on our own show, and then I make a big deal out of it because we're so humble. And that's why I've been telling the listeners and viewers that InfoWars is so successful at changing the global narrative, at exposing the New World Order, the corporate tyranny, the crony capitalist system. I don't get up here and say, hey, by the way, we're the tip of the spear, you're the tip of the spear, just as hyperbole. I say it because it's true, and I'm always, in the last few years, been too humble to say it, but we need to say it to understand the nature of the war we're in. So I want to salute you. I want to commend you. I want to thank you. You know, we've been playing with this voice changer piece of equipment so that members of the media or whistleblowers can call in and speak without their voice being recognizable. Is that hooked up and ready yet, guys? Good, it is. I want to open the phones up because one of the biggest groups we get contacted by is people in mainstream media, and I mean inside Rolling Stone, inside MSNBC, inside CNN, inside Fox News, inside everything. A lot of times they get mad because I can't call them back or whatever, and a lot of times they're reporters, they're researchers, they're journalists, they're writers, and they get pissed like, this is really important. Alex can't call me, and sometimes they're prominent people, and I'm just like, man, there's stacks of this coming in. Just give us the information. And we will, you know, not say who you are. In fact, we delete the stuff out of the email once we get it or the things like that. I mean, we have all sorts of procedures. Not that we're perfect. Nobody is. And we're under major attack, so God knows what's going to happen. Just pray for us. But, in fact, will you guys bring me our local number? I don't have a copy of it in the studio. Thanks. I want to open the phones up so members of the media, I forget about the idea for this last week, but it's a great idea, can call in and actually talk about what you witnessed, talk about what you've seen, talk about what you've been told to do. Because when you see every newspaper in the country every day doing nothing but attacking Trump, and they don't even put in another op-ed saying something nice about Trump, when the coverage is 100-1, and I mean that when I say it, I mean it's 100-1 against Trump, totally distorted, you know you're dealing with a country in deep trouble. And you're dealing with a power structure that is in full panic, who has robbed us up one side and down the other. So here's your chance. You can call right into our phone system, and it is absolutely anonymous. You can go on air, and you can give us a brief account of what you're witnessing. Maybe you agree with the system, and you'll obviously be able to call in. But we'll be able to tell when we take the call if you're really a media person, because you'll be well-spoken, focused, and have information. We're not obviously vetting and saying all these are 100% real media calls. But the point is that if you've got whistleblower information about the media and you want us to expose that, see, they've got all these government, quote, protections around tyranny now in the name of national security, but there's nothing that says people in the media can't whistleblow, even though the media is operating as the propaganda force of these offshore multinationals that have hijacked the country. 877-789-ALEX, 877-789-2539. And that's 877-789-2539. 877-789-2539. If you don't want to voice change yourself and you're with the media, maybe you think they won't notice who you are or whatever. I don't think that's probably a smart move. You could call the network number. Or maybe you can call in on your own system. A lot of folks have voice changers on their phones. You can do that as well. And that number is the standard number, 800-259-9231. But 877-789-ALEX is the number to call in. We'll be taking your calls coming up at the bottom of the hour. If you just joined us, the globalists have made a critical error. They have been operating their ongoing takeover program as if they were still in the 1980s or 70s, and have believed that they've had air superiority with the dinosaur collaborator media, discrediting or attempting to discredit or spinning true independent media that's exposing their crimes. And they made an even bigger error in a string of them when I came out over a month ago and had a special message to Donald Trump dealing with election fraud. I personally talked to him as well, obviously. And he didn't so much do what I told him to do. He already concurred and absolutely was on the same page and was already right there with me or even ahead of me. But I encouraged him to basically ignore some of the people telling him not to go with that and to go all the way, because if they stole it from Sanders and they try to steal it from him nakedly in the primaries, and they've got a history of it, that Homeland Security was going to go in and probably bring in UN observers to make sure illegals and people could vote and change the debate away from election fraud to retail voter fraud, which is individuals cheating rather than the computers being hacked. And I said, you got to do it while you're still way ahead in the polls, because they're going to start skewing the polls, obviously, and saying you're behind. That's standard tactic. You need to go now with this information, so that when you're actually still ahead, you talk about the fraud. You'll be ahead all the way through, but they're going to put out the fake polls that you're way behind to actually create that perception. And obviously Trump was right there, and Trump did it. That's why they're so scared of him. I mean, they are having to put on adult diapers over this guy, okay? And obviously Trump has his own experts that were telling him the same thing. He's really smart. He understands how things operate. They already tried to steal it from him. He stood up and contested it, so he got it. Sanders didn't, so he lost it. And then Trump comes out 2 days after I talked to him and after I put the message out. I talked to him that day, and then I came in. I called Rob Jacobson up. He was on that weekend. I said, we're shooting a video of a message to Trump. I said, it's really a message to the people. I've already delivered the message to Trump that day. But we're gonna put this video out, explaining this to people and showing the fraud that's already happened, and the fact, you know, the history of fraud, and the fact that Trump has to build an army to fight election fraud, which he's now doing. And that's why they are in a conniption fit to send in their federal army to say, no, we're the feds and the UN. We say we didn't steal it. Don't listen to the KKK / Russian Trump people. I mean, you talk about conspiracy theory. That is ridiculous. Russia can barely operate its country and feed its people under economic sanctions. The idea that Russia is pulling my, let me tell you what's pulling my strings my conscience and my commitment to this nation. We've already been conquered by globalist multinationals. We're not being conquered by the Russians. The same globalists that have conquered us are trying to reconquer Russia right now. Just like the Germans, the Nazis attacked the United States and the Russians, same deal. But this time it's not Uncle Joe Stalin who was evil, so you kind of go, ooh, what do I do? It's not. They're not. This is so incredible, ladies and gentlemen. Think about this. Russia kicked all these oligarchs out that had been managing the communists for 80-something years. Putin starts arresting them. They're always Rockefeller and Rothschild front. The Rothschilds sue over it. Comes out in court. The British High Court goes, this actually proves everything they said about you. You're horrible. Imagine a judge standing up to Lord Rothschild. You can go read the articles and saying this case actually proved not just that your case of slander and libel fails against these newspapers, but this really shows what you did to Russia. The exact same people are gang raping this country right now. So, of course, Russia's sitting there watching it. The globalists occupy the U.S., use all our force against them while they're screwing us over. The Russians are just bleeding out, flopping around on the ground. The New World Order is just running all these desperate jihadis all over the planet, slaughtering people, destabilizing us. They're breaking our families down. They're bankrupting us. They've imploded our borders. We are falling, just like 1917 in Russia, people. They're going to come after everybody. You understand how screwed we are? This is not a game. This is not a radio show. The reason all the former brass expelled by Obama listen to the show, because it's the only place they can tune in and hear something that resembles the truth. Not because they're learning anything from me. They already know it. Even current generals tell me and others, and my father when he was in a meeting with some of them, that this show is basically 100% accurate on what's going on. It's not hard to be 100% accurate. The very same robber baron families that took over Russia and were financed in 1917 are literally gang raping us right now. And Trump knows all this. Trump gets it. He's going, we got these globalist New World Order people. We got the Chinese. We're cleaning you out. And they know what Trump said. He's going to arrest Hillary. Oh, yeah. You know what? It's on, folks. You know why Trump's so confident? He knows what's going to happen if they try to pull some big coup thing, counter coup against this. I'm telling you, folks, we are sitting on top a mountain of TNT right now. And nobody's blinking. We're going in, through, and beyond. I remember when they would have all these articles, even a local paper, saying, Jones is crazy. He claims there's secret army drills happen. I'd have video of the black helicopters and drills. I wasn't against the military. They would also say that. I was just like, no, these drills are going on. Stop denying you're doing them. And Clinton was doing it not to train people, but to acclimate the public, the troops on the streets. Clinton was thinking about martial law. It's come out. I've interviewed Thomas Sanchez, the head of emergency management in Kingsville, the San Antonio police chief at the time, Ali Philippus, and others. When they were approached and asked, would they support Clinton in a martial law takeover? And, of course, all that did was educate the Delta Force, who they had going around trying to sell everybody on this. Because who better than these strong, you know, patriot, really smart soldiers to do the corruption? There's nothing new under the sun. That's who Julius Caesar would use, would be like famous war heroes to go corrupt people. They redid it in the HBO special Rome, where he hires the war hero guy to go do the corruptions. He goes, you're getting him so cheaply. I need to have you do all my corruptions. But as they thought they were corrupting people, they were only educating everyone. So good luck with your plan for gun confiscation. Good luck for your plan with civil war. They're trying to prime a race war, just like they used civil unrest in Ukraine to overthrow it. This is George Soros quantum garbage. Now, let's go to these clips again if you just joined us, because we've had dozens and dozens of callers call in, but no media yet. It's media right now, folks. Only media that want to talk about what it's like working in establishment media. Or maybe you disagree with me in your establishment media. You know, Media Matters can call in, but they never do anything real. They're also scripted, so controlled. 877-789-ALEX, 877-789-2539. And folks calling in who aren't media, don't let us get to the other folks that are. So please don't call right now if you're not media. Now, continuing, here is Obama a month ago before Hillary named the name that not be named. Oh, that's out of Texas. Oh, I mean, the feds aren't involved in elections. Now they're announcing the feds, Homeland Security, Obama, Jay Johnson, to take over elections. It's being announced. Homeland ICE special declaration to take charge of elections. The Department of Homeland Security began considering declaration of the election as a critical infrastructure and now says they want to do it. And they're already over it, bringing in UN and EU, OECD watchers. Let's go ahead and go to Lord Obama.
Of course, the elections will not be rigged. What does that mean? The federal government doesn't run the election process. States and cities and communities all across the country, they're the ones who set up the voting systems.
Oh, really?
Voting booths. And if Mr. Trump is suggesting that there is a conspiracy theory,
I thought the votes didn't matter, they said, for Bernie Sanders,
being propagated across the country, including in places like Texas, where typically it's not Democrats who are in charge of voting booths.
Oh, yeah? They're so arrogant, they think they're going to win Texas. They're stealing everything. Okay, now suddenly Homeland Security is going to run the elections, though. Because people now know it's mainstream media that announces who wins. The fraud's out. People are watching. So now they're going to come in for more legitimacy. It's not AP now and CNN. It's Jay Johnson. When Loretta Lynch isn't meeting with Clinton on an airplane, she's running her elections. So let's go ahead now and go to this other clip. This is Jay Johnson projecting onto Trump everything he is. The guy that's going to run the election says you can't have Trump. He's disqualified. There's no conflict of interest. He shouldn't recuse himself. And again, I'm a Chinese jet pilot. Here it is.
As the Secretary of Homeland Security, I have avoided responding to the political season and what candidates have said running for president. However, I believe that it's the responsibility of those of us in national security and Homeland Security when a leading candidate for office proposes something that is irresponsible, probably illegal, unconstitutional, and contrary law, un-American, and will actually hurt our efforts at Homeland Security and national security, we have to speak out.
And he goes on to demonize Trump. Why don't you then have feds oversee elections? Well, I've actually met a lot of the feds. They're actually more awake than the public. They're totally freaked out. I'm not defending all the stuff they do, but I mean, they got to bring foreigners in.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex,
we'll be back.
And the GCN radio network.
Oh, my God. In the movie V for Vendetta, towards the end, when the police inspector is meeting with V in a disguise, he doesn't know it's V till the end. He says, why didn't you do something about this before? Why didn't you take action? Why didn't you stop this false flag bioweapon attack? Why did you expose it? And he said, I was waiting for you, Inspector. I was waiting for you. Very powerful movie. I really admire the Wachowski brother and sister for their work because it really says it all, doesn't it? That movie is so powerful. I'm waiting for you. You're waiting for me. And again, it's the minute the police understand the larger criminal conspiracy of the globalists, which they write books about. They think we're dumb. It's over. That's why they want us to have a war with police. That's why they tried to corrupt the police. Because then they can come in multinationally and purge the police and be big heroes and have these truth and reconciliation commissions the UN has and then bring in total tyranny. And then the police are going to sit back and allow the persecution of patriots, just like YouTube. If you just joined us, a woman who's a feminist, a pretty big feminist, does a feminist journal, a publication, runs groups, is a horrible example for women, in my view. There's an Asian guy with a hula girl tastefully dressed on his dashboard just for fun, you know, happy thing. Not degrading Hawaiians. Anymore, we had a bobblehead of a cowboy or something. I mean, it's just something fun to be, hey, you're in my cab. She bullies him for 6-7 minutes, cusses at him, tells him she's going to basically ruin his career, put him on Gawker. I can't wait to hurt you. I can't wait to hurt you. YouTube community Guidelines organization concurred and removed Laura Southern's YouTube channel. She's challenging it because she said this woman's a bully when she's clearly a bully. So speaking out against their bullying, and that's the YouTube diversity team. Gil White. I bet Gil White's white. I'm not bashing white people, but I'm telling you, the worst social justice warriors, the most commissariat, abusive, getting off on it, race-baiting controllers are the white college students that George Soros sends that do the chants, deck the halls with dead cops. And then when one of the black teenagers actually shoots a cop, they get killed, their life's ruined. The Soros piece of filth just scurries off into the dark. Those are the people that grand juries need to start indicting. Indict the asses of these college students that are calling for murder. They're organizing crime. If I did that, I'd be arrested like that. By the way, I don't call for it because I want to bring everybody together. But I'll say this. I'm not somebody that shoots my mouth off about physical stuff. But the New World Order obviously knows. I mean, if you think we've begun to fight so far with the hacks and everything and risking our lives and not caring what you do to us, can you imagine if you actually ever take the gloves off for real? I mean, you people are crazy. There won't be anywhere in the world you can hide. Nowhere. Ever. You have successfully pissed off more than 10 million veterans who are below the age of 55. They're almost all becoming experts on who you are and what you do. And they aren't people that are bloodthirsty. They just are hoping we can fix things peacefully. If we can't, you're going to last as long as a bottle of red wine in a hobo encampment. And I don't take any pleasure imagining rotting, demonic piles of filth dying. I just want you out of my life. I want you to go back to the catacombs where you came from. I mean, I don't like, my life isn't about some pissing contest to beat the New World Order just because I want to beat you. I want you off our back. Understand that? And I'm committed, and I've put my will and my spirit, everything I've got against you. And you can feel it, can't you? Because here's the little secret. Good people have more will and more guts and more spirit than you evil people do any day. And you know that. That's why you've always been trying to brain damage us at birth and make us as stupid as possible while you don't give vaccines to your kids. So you hope your little stunted demon kids can beat us in the real world. It's not happening. And the fact that we're aware of who you are, you realize that we've got our arm, like Beowulf, around your arm. And we're not letting go. So you take us wherever you're taking us. But see, you're going with us. It's like that intro we had earlier. Maybe we should play it again in the next segment. I'm coming down fast, but I'm miles above you. You understand that? Yes, you've taken me down. You've taken my family down. You've hurt me, and I'm going to hurt you right back. But here's the thing. I'm hurting you a lot worse than you're hurting me, and you know that, don't you? Because I will never back down to you people. And you see, this is just the beginning. Just like tyrants fall every time, you are going to fall. And you're going to be an example to everyone else on how to not be a scumbag. And I'll be honest with you, more and more, because the epic energy that's rising right now, I get tears in my eyes. It's not even tears of sadness or pain. It's tears of joy. Of joy. Because since the foundations of this earth were laid down, this contest was meant to happen. And this contest has happened over and over again. But we are in a time of the greatest contest this species has ever faced. And we're entering the crucible right now. And I am so humbled to be at the center of the crucible. And I'm going to tell you, our listeners and our viewers and our affiliates and the station managers and our sponsors and everyone, you are just as important as Donald Trump or Matt Drudge or myself. That's something Matt Drudge, I've learned, tells reporters all the time that are independent for decades. You're just as important as the New York Times. You're just as important as the Washington Post. You matter. You're important. I tell my crew that. It's not arrogance. We need to realize we're more important. They're sold out known liars. We want to tell the truth. Damn it, we hate it when we make a mistake. We want to be honest. I want to be good. Because it feels so good to be good and to be closer to God. And Lord knows I take the Lord's name in vain. I cuss. I do bad things. It's just who I am. I lust after women. I eat too much. I do it all. But you know, at the end of the day, my soul's pointed towards God like a North Star. It's not pointed towards wanting to screw people over, wanting to dumb people down, wanting to pray and have big, huge hordes of poor people. What the hell is that? We don't need to be ruled by that. But we have to wake up to it if we're ever going to change it. We got a news reporter, Julio in Illinois. We're going to go to him in a moment. I actually know this reporter. He's leaked a lot of stuff to us over the years. Worked in TV, radio, you name it. And so he's the only reporter that has the courage to call in. We've had hundreds of calls come in now. No reporters are calling. You send us stuff, whatever you're scared to call in. We even have a voice changer. No need to change Julio's voice. Julio's been calling in for 10 years since he was a college student. But since I'm in the interest of time, I'm not going to even belabor this. Buy the Hillary for President t-shirts at cost. Spread the word. Bioavailable. Selenium, everybody needs it. It's amazing. Talk about an energy booster. Electrochemical, goes with the X2, makes an iodine. 20% off the great vitamin mineral fusion, amino acid, fruit punch drink we have that's so, again, absorbable, great for your kids to drink, send them to school with it, you name it. We need to fund the operation. That's what everybody knows. I mean, I can just sit there and say, send me, you know, donations, whatever. The point is, we need funds to fund this operation. We're doing it. We're expanding in the face of the enemy. We're all in. And I want to thank you for your support. I want to play a few clips here first, though. We've had Dr. Drew 5+ years on CNN, one of the top-rated shows in that crap house that is headline news. And he's not even really a conservative from what I researched, more like a libertarian. He's not really worried about Hillary. She does look bad. And the two drugs she's on, Coumadin and Armored Thyroid, counterbalance and it'll kill you. I mean, what the hell's going on with her doctors? I'd like to talk to Hillary. 3 days later, you're fired. We're paying out your contract. Get out of here. Get your stuff and get out. And all these other doctors. Now, Obama's former doctor. Infowars.com has it. The Hill reported it as well. Clinton should have a neurological exam. The clip we play of 2 weeks ago of her in Nevada, where she's sitting there, and this person just says something in the crowd.
You're okay. Keep talking. You handle it.
Keep talking. You're all right.
Here we are.
If that isn't a bag lady, I don't mean to bag ladies, but I mean she's gone. I don't have a PhD in psychology, but I've talked to folks that do. They go, yeah, she's clearly disassociating. Psychotic, doesn't know what frickin' planet she's on, and she's got a handler going, you're all right, continue, and then she twitches into her act. The woman is under judgment. She's cursed. Heck, there's a sick part of me hopes she gets in, because it's only going to wipe people up. They're going to put Trump in and blame him for everything and then implode everything. They're already planning it, but they know how slick he is, and he'll be able to deal with it. Ah, man. Justice be done, may the heavens fall. I'm trying to get Trump in, but no one should be bored right now. We got front row seats to what could potentially be Armageddon. And guess what? Even if you lie to yourself and think you're in the cheap seats, the nosebleeds, every man, woman, and child, I don't care where you're from or what color your skin is, your blood's red and your soul is on the line and you're in the arena. That's the big secret. People think they can set outside things and they're in charge, and they can comment. No, everybody's in the arena. So now Obama's former doctor says she needs a neurological exam. This is on CNN. Here it is.
Trump has said, Dr. Steiner, he'll release his medical records if, and only if, Hillary Clinton releases hers. Now, she did release a two-page letter from her doctor with real
not her doctor,
information,
including
some
fake.
Of the things you mentioned, cholesterol, things like that. It also talked about
not her year, not her year in surgery, you know.
When she had a concussion and a blood cut in her brain. And in this, the letter says she had follow-up testing in 2013, which revealed complete resolution of the effects of the concussion, as well as total dissolution of the thrombosis. Mrs. Clinton also tested negative for all clotting disorders. Is that enough?
No. There are a number of questions I have. First of all, she's also 68 years old, and I think, while I think that medical letter was well written and was very professional, unlike Dr. Bornstein's, it's not enough. For example, she is on Coumadin, a medication to prevent blood clots.
Rat poison.
And you have to monitor that, and it says that she's being monitored regularly. I'd like to know how well she is being controlled. That's a difficult drug to use. Also, I think she should have had a neurological examination, a thorough neurological examination in 2016. We know what happens to football players who have had concussions, how they begin to lose some of their cognitive ability. I think both of them should release their records.
Which is what Dr. Pechenik said, who, by the way, has been friends with Hillary Clinton. The guy's not a Republican. He says she has to go. Here's the baseball, folks, and this gets serious with medical records and things. Hillary Clinton had a brain tumor removed is the info. And they think it's growing back 3 years later. She's not long for this world. She wants to talk about my black heart all day? Lady, give me a break. I'm ready to stand before God right now. Not in an arrogant way. But I know I love God. If I've done bad things and God turns me away, I don't blame God. You think God's going to turn me away? You say, I've got a dark heart, lady, give me a break. I'm not involved in the murder of hundreds of thousands of Christians like you. All right, we got news reporters calling in. I'm going to skip this network break so we have more time. I'm going to go to Mike in PA first, report for daily newspaper in PA. Then we're going to go to Julio in Illinois. You're on the air. Go ahead, Mike.
Alex, how's it going?
Good, brother. Go ahead.
Great. You know, I go into the office every day and sitting there and just listening to my editors and the other reporters just going off constantly about how much of a warmonger Trump is, how insane he is. I just kind of sit back and laugh to myself as I listen to them talk, kind of keeping some things to myself, but definitely it reaches points where I just start breaking out laughing when they start talking. Lately, I've been bringing up some of the health issues, and they just think that I'm making these things up. And I print off articles, mainstream articles, pretty much anything I could find, and hand it to them. Like, look, I'm not making this stuff
she's
up.
She's had a bunch of brain surgery. She's falling down. She doesn't know who she is. In her own WikiLeaks, she wants Parkinson's medication. She's on weird blood thinners and stuff they haven't used in 40 years. Medical doctors are getting fired that... Talk about it. What do you think is going on with her?
Honestly, I think she is breaking down. I think that she probably does have Parkinson's or something similar to that. And I think she's realizing, and the people around her are realizing, that she doesn't have much time. And they need to do whatever they can to get her in so that they can get the plan continuing down the road, even if she's not around to be a part of it.
That's right. That's what Dr. Pechenik told us today. He's coming on the next few days. The word is they're already preparing Kane. And again, I have guests on that don't make stuff up. I mean, if they say they've got the intel, they've got it. And Hillary is not long for this world. I mean, and I'm not threatening her. The media will say, like, we have this deal where you talk about her campaign's disintegrating. It's like her blowing away. And they go, oh, the news, he wants to, that's her head being blown off. I don't wish any harm against Hillary. They want me to say that because then they can green light taking me out. That's kind of how this works. Look, if I thought it would save the world for Hillary to have something bad happen to her, then I would be honest about it. I don't want anything physical to happen to her. She's just a front puppet. but a very nasty one. But I do want to see her prosecuted so we can roll up all the foreign assets that are controlling her. But getting back to your newsroom, that's what I see around leftists, is this hype. Have you seen the New York Times, Washington Post? They write articles this week and last week saying, we need to be more unimpartial and more hateful. And so what if we're lying about Trump? He's bad. I mean, I've never imagined I'd see articles from the New York Times calling for more vitriol and lashing the media for not being more hateful. I mean, this is crazy.
I tell you what, though, there's a newspaper, the Patriot News, which actually won a Pulitzer a few years ago.
No, it is, yes.
Coverage of the Sandusky Penn Live. There's a columnist, John Micek, that's on there. Every single day, he has an anti-Trump column. It's like he's the anti-Trump beat. But if you go on the comments section and look at the comments that people are writing, people are not buying it at all. I mean, 10 to 1, it's anti, just saying, you know, this is a total joke.
Oh, you're, I know liberals who are good people who don't like Republicans because of, you know, abortion and wars or whatever. And I get, the war stuff. I hate the Republican establishment. But they're like, yeah, I've never opened the New York Times up and every article is like foaming at the mouth. The Washington Post, CNN, foaming. I mean, they have just totally dropped any pretense of objectivity. And I mean, who knows what's going to happen? Let me ask you this question. When you're talking to all these reporters and writers around you, are they in a bubble or do they understand that this has become an incredible spectacle?
Well, here's another thing. The political reporter who sits right across from me the other day, she's like, do you know what the alt-right is? And I just started laughing and she started watching the Washington Post video that they made of what they're quote unquote what the alt right is, and I said, well, look at these people they're talking about. Nigel Farage, he's not extreme. These people are not extreme.
These are sane people
talking about how horrible Breitbart is. You are so every point that she brings up is 100% mainstream leftist talking points that she brings up, and that's what she writes about politically. It's amazing.
Well, that shows how disconnected they are. I mean, when you've got Greenberg and all these other people coming out that are like real liberals, respected guys that expose Bush, and now Obama's doing bad and Hillary is, they're exposing it. These are good liberals. These are the good liberals I grew up around. I mean, I'm a libertarian. I'm not a right-winger guy. The issue is, they're so committed to hating Republicans, they'll do anything for the Democrats. I wonder if they're ever going to wake up from their trance. I mean, what did she say when you pointed out, this is WikiLeaks. This was the hero of the left just 6, 7, 8 years ago. Why do you now hate him?
Well, you know, I look back, I was pretty involved with the anti-war movement, going to protests and just looking at these people. And some of these same people I see were in newsrooms being part of the protest. I'm like, where are these people now? Where have they gone? Do you not realize? Look at the list of the people who are supporting Hillary. This is something that I brought up the other day. Paul Wolfowitz, Dov Zakheim, Michael Chertoff, the right wing of all right wing.
The ultimate warmongers, the ultimate war pigs.
Yeah, and their comeback is, well, Dick Cheney supports Trump, so that's their only comeback. Oh, Dick Cheney supports him.
Well, all I know is this. Trump is an unknown quantity to a certain extent. I'm not going to claim I know he's perfect, but we know what we've got here with Hillary, and the fact that people claim they're anti-establishment, this is the time then to stand up against the establishment. Great points, Mike. Thank you so much, and you can tell that's a real reporter, smart guy, who's sitting here and you know, talking to him. You could tell, probably a classical liberal, you know, a real nice guy that's smart and wants everybody to have freedom. And he's just looking at all these fascist reporters acting completely insane and throwing total objectivity out the window and distorting what Trump says. He's just like, man, this is crazy. This is crazy. Julio, who I know is a radio host and also a newspaper reporter. He's called in for years. Julio, what is your take on all this? Why do you think the Homeland Security is, quote, taking over the election?
Well, just look at the polls, Alex, and I hope you're doing well. Look at the polls of corporate media and their and how much the people distrust corporate media here in the state. It's not a surprise to me to see Homeland Security doing this. Being in Chicago, it's the third largest market in the country behind Los Angeles and New York City. And a lot of these reporters, I've had experience as an intern and then moving back to Chicago recently and working as a radio news reporter for a statewide news agency. A lot of these reporters in Chicago on the TV side are quite comfortable. High salaries. They're worried about pushing the envelope and getting canned by the most stations in Chicago are owned and operated by the big networks. Their career.
And Dr. Drew was the message. It doesn't matter how high your ratings are. You even say you want to help Hillary, you're fired.
Yeah, it's unbelievable to see the bias. I've covered the Republican debate in Vegas back in December. I've covered the Illinois presidential primary.
You were a big detractor of Bush. I protested Bush with you.
It's amazing to see and to talk, converse with some of these reporters or even hearing them. Mostly I'm silent when I cover some of these events because I like a sponge. I want to absorb everything I hear from sources. It's amazing to hear the bias from some of these reporters, how they're working with their editors, working with their news directors, working with other reporters for opposing news organizations to do what they can to support their particular candidate. In this instance, in the presidential primary, it's Hillary Clinton. And to see...
I was about to say, I've never seen such coordination between media to lie. They get together with the unified BS of the day. It's crazy.
It's what another reason that is, Alex, is because a lot of these stations, despite them, is, you know, here in Chicago in high rise buildings, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful buildings.
Stay there. Come back in 70 seconds, Julio. We'll be back. Stay with us. Let's go to Julio in Illinois, news reporter for a statewide news agency. We'll stop right there. Finish your points, Julio. Very informative. Go ahead.
So a lot of the stations in Chicago and throughout the big markets across the country are so dependent on newswire services. I worked at a small radio station in Wyoming, and smaller markets, that's all they can get is newswires.
They're repeaters.
They're repeaters, Alex. And so when you have Agence France-Presse, or you have Reuters, or you have Associated Press, or you have even these big markets, Fox, NBC, et cetera, churning out the same types of garbage, the same types of biased reports, they get picked up all over the just based off of the budget constraints by so many of these news organizations, big market, media market, small market, they're all.
And then Drudge comes along, or InfoWars comes along, and listeners send us videos, their own articles. That just creates an alternative, and more radio stations, TV stations are actually tuning into that alternative view. That's why they say, oh, don't go to Drudge or InfoWars. That's discredited, but that doesn't work anymore. So, Julio, in 30 seconds, how do they counter that? They shut the web down.
Well, of course, they shut the web down. Stations buy up more and more stations, fire the departments, and then keep churning and burning the same type of garbage. I had an interview with the largest news wiring service in the country recently, and during the interview I talked about we just started shooting the breeze about the election. I asked, what do you think about this nationalist trend? We see it in France with Marie Le Pen. We see it in Britain, in the UK with Nigel Farage. We're seeing sort of a new dichotomy in politics, and it's happening right here in the States. Sort of happened a little bit with the Tea Party, but it's now flourishing with Donald Trump. And this guy from the largest news wiring service in the country told me to my face, yeah, but here in the States, it's more of the racist far right. And, we think that, it's going to end here.
That's all they've got. Listen, Julio, I have met you several times. I've seen your work. You've leaked this great info. We ought to talk to you about working for InfoWars. Would you want to move down here to Texas?
I'm in a position now where I can do more independent stuff. Would love to contribute in any way possible. You see,
I got your number years ago. We've talked, hung out in D.C., you name it, in Chicago. But send me your info right now. Give me your number. I'm serious. I'm wanting to hire a few more reporters. I was just thinking, just click. This guy's always done great reports. You're not saying, of course, your full name right now because they'll probably fire you from your job. But we ought to just hire the real reporters. That's what we're trying to do here. Julio, we'll talk to you very, very soon. Give us your info. I'm going to have Rob do call you. And And even if you don't move down here, we can have an auxiliary and, you know, pay us somewhat of a salary to be up there in Chicago. But Julio's a go-getter, and he's a smart guy. We need that guy. That's why I need you to buy the products, the T-shirts. Well, I'm selling those at cost, so I guess not those. The Vitamin Mineral Fusion, 20% off. The Great Organic Mustard Seed-Based Selenium, BioTrue Selenium, exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com. The Super Male Vitality, the Anthroplex, and so many other products, because it funds the operation. And you see what we have here is these great reporters and crew and researchers. InfoWarsLife.com. Or call toll-free 888-253-3139. We've got more reporters like J.T. Coyote, who wrote for the Colorado News. We'll be back. Stay with us straight ahead. Dr. Corsi is joining us. Well, Dr. Jerome Corsi is joining us. He is a, is it two-time or three-time number one New York Times bestseller? And he has the new book out, Always Definitive, Partners in Crime. If there's somebody writing the reality-based narrative in so many elections, it is Dr. Corsi. They fear this man as much as they probably fear somebody like Matt Drudge. And that's hard company to keep. I don't think there's probably anybody in that fraternity. But Jerome R. Corsi, Ph.D., really an expert on the economy. I want to ask him just selfishly, separately, about the Germans clearing the store shelves. Government says get ready for civil emergency. That was last Friday, got almost no coverage. That was a government announcement. What's happening with all these Soros emails coming out? Worse than I even thought about the UN taking over the internet. Now it happens next month. I mean, it's like my worst concerns have now been like magnified and are happening. So I'm wondering from Dr. Corsi what he sees coming up next. But Dr. Corsi is an expert on the economy, so we'll also get his take on that. In fact, going over his bio, he's a Ph.D. from Harvard in political science. He is currently a senior staff reporter at WorldNet Daily, where he works as an investigative reporter, WND.com. He's an expert on political violence and terrorism and worked in, as a consultant in a lot of clandestine areas. In 81, he received a top-secret clearance for the Agency for International Development, where he assisted in providing anti-terrorism training to embassy personnel. 25 years, beginning in 81, he developed working and banks throughout the United States and around the world to develop financial services marketing companies to assist banks in establishing broker-dealers and insurance subsidiaries to provide financial planning products. So he revolutionized that whole area and services, including working for Trump, I would add, as a consultant, to their retail customers. He is a noted financial services speaker. That's really where he's the most prestigious, not just as a writer. But obviously, the average listener doesn't know that because they're not into, you know, banking. And he's published many, many books, many of them New York Times bestsellers, WND.com, Twitter.com/Corsi_ or Jerome Corsi. Wow, where to begin? Obviously, the economy, his book, so many fronts, but the clips. I've already played them twice, so I won't play them again, or maybe later. Obama says a month ago, what's election fraud? The feds don't run elections. Well, we know they've been caught, the party in power, before directing voter news services and the media the way the announcements are supposed to go. But now Homeland Security and Jay Johnson are announcing special executive action to defend the infrastructure and come in and, quote, protect it. And as Roger Stone said a month ago, watch if Homeland Security comes in to protect the machines. That's the fix. It's like prophecy. It's happening. So this is simply over the top. And then I have Reuters from last week, where the Organization of Economic Cooperative Development, that's really at the heart of globalism, from the Marshall Plan, it's OSCE, this multinational NATO Interpol group, is going to oversee, with 10 times the people they had last time, 500 monitors our election. So Obama's gone from the feds aren't involved to bringing foreigners in. I mean, this is so sensational. With George Soros emails saying have the UN run a local police, that it's like I'm a dog in a butcher shop. It proves everything. It's surreal, though. Dr. Corsi, I've thrown a big gestalt out there. Where do we begin? I mean, this is crazy.
Well, I think you're exposing the heart of the corruption that we're facing here, Alex. I mean, to begin with, you don't have an unbiased source when you've got Department of Homeland Security coming in with Jay Johnson to supervise the elections. I mean, it's like saying the IRS is an unbiased source when it won't give out any 501c3s to conservative groups, or that the Department of Justice is unbiased when it won't prosecute Hillary Clinton, even though it's clear that Hillary Clinton is extremely careless with her classified emails as Secretary of State. I mean, this bias of the corrupt Obama administration and the corrupt Clinton administration, I think, has got to be frightening. But, Alex, you've got the globalists scared to death of Donald Trump, and they're running as fast as they can to get to the finish line, to put in global government and to eliminate fundamental freedoms Americans experience under the Constitution as fast as they can.
Let me ask you this. Obviously, you've got a lot of really high-level contacts. When they have no fewer than 20-plus articles last month in The Economist, the Financial Times of London, the Washington Post, the New York Times, the Atlantic Monthly, all the globalist organs saying globalism with Brexit is in deep trouble. If one more domino falls, if Hillary doesn't win, we're done. Red level panic. Do anything. Get her in. I mean, it seems like they're in a panic. Is that a put on, or why are they acting suddenly so scared?
Well, I think, Alex, globalists are scared. I think finally people are waking up. I mean, you've done a tremendous job of getting the message
out. Well, you've done the job really documenting it for decades.
We've all been fighting this battle to get the people of the United States and around the world to realize that one world government is enslavement. It's enslavement by the transnational corporate structure and their power brokers in both the Democratic and Republican Party, to force the United States into a European Union. You're also going to see tremendous articles and pressure about Obama panicking that he's not going to be able to get this Trans-Pacific.
That's what they're saying. They admit TPP's in deep doo-doo.
Deep trouble. And, what the Brexit, I think, shows is that despite the elites, despite the Paul Ryan and McConnell's, with the charade of the Republican Party as a conservative party, which at its core it is not, they're worried to death that they're going to lose control over the populations which dare to vote against the Brexit. And we're seeing the same thing now, the drum roll, Trump is going to lose, give up, don't vote, it's all over, Hillary's already won. I mean,
Tokyo Rose stuff.
Exactly, precisely. All propaganda, all aimed at discouraging those of us who know that the populism that's building around the world is a pushback against the enslavement.
So let me ask you this then, as one of the architects of defeating this over 40 years, and as you told us, Trump's for real. I've been talking to him for 40 years. He knows everything we know and more. He's obviously anti-New World Order. It's why they're crapping their pants. Americanism, not globalism, will be our credo. I see them losing either way. If they steal it, they lose. Authoritarianism won't prop this up in what's left of our open society. Their whole program relies on stealth, as their own documents from BAMP Canada that you put out and others put out show. So what do they do? I mean, I don't want to be overconfident here, but it does seem that the tide has really shifted. The tables have turned.
Well, I mean, I expect a massive, violent kind of effort before this is over. I mean, there's going to be either a war, there'll be an assassination attempt, there'll be some, thing to frighten the American people into thinking the only way we can survive as a nation is if we let the Department of Homeland Security, the Department of Justice, and the IRS rule the nation. And they will rule it not for justice. They're going to rule it for the Clinton elite, for the Obama elite, for the elite in the GOP as well. Believe me, these GOP and the Democratic Party are not two parties. They are two wings of the same party. And that's what Donald Trump is. Yes, Donald Trump is the real deal. I've known Donald Trump. I've talked to him. He truly does believe in America.
I've been on the phone with you before when you had to get off like 10 years ago when Donald Trump was calling up. Like, yes, I got to go. Donald Trump's calling up.
Right. So. I remember that too. Yeah, that's right. I mean, Donald Trump is he's a really sincere guy. If you get to know Donald Trump, as part of what gets him into trouble with the media is
he gets all this energy. He's in the epic battle. He knows it. He told me, he said, use the energy. He goes, it's so good. I mean, he just loves it.
Well, and in fact, he dares to say what is on his mind to say, whether it's politically correct or not. And look at the moves he's taking. He's going to go to Mexico. He's daring to now start calling out Hillary and Bill Clinton on the foundation. And I wrote this book because I think the foundation is the Achilles.
Let's talk about the book, because you've been writing it over the last year. Now it's here. It's all coming out. The Chinese president, pay to play. I mean, this is incredible. If somebody doesn't indict her, it seems like the sky's the limit, because other people are going to be involved in espionage and say, hey, you did nothing to Hillary.
Well, and I wrote the book to point out that the crime here is not just pay to play, but it's Enormant. Enormant is using a foundation for personal gain. And anyone who's contributed a dollar to the foundation can go to a state attorney general, and at that state attorney general, file a criminal complaint against the Clinton administration.
And doesn't Trump have standing? Because he got bullied into giving money to too.
Trump has standing to go to the New York attorney general. Good luck getting the New York attorney general to pay any attention. That's the problem. Again, you've got Democratic Party politics wiring the situation.
And if an attorney general in Texas starts doing the right thing, they indict him.
Precisely. Or any state. Any one state can close down the Clinton Foundation internationally, because it can demand, until their criminal investigation is finished, that the foundation not function to defraud anybody else. And that's a key point. My book, Partners in Crime, showing how the Clintons have used the White House to enrich themselves, which they have. It's been their only job, and they have $100 million each net worth. It can be shut down by ordinary citizens demanding their state attorney generals investigate.
And so people should do it now, and no one loses who does it, because it draws attention to it. What do you make then, and we're about to go to break, come back and answer this, we can start answering it. What do you make by the fact that they have all these other secret bank accounts in the foundation and they don't report out of Canada? I'm sure it's well more than $200 million.
Oh, and also pass-through accounts with secret shell corporations, WJC.
Because that's what you're an expert on, is banking. So when we come back with Dr. Jerome Corsi, we're going to talk about, look, if they brought in $6-7 billion at the foundation and $69 billion in their global initiative, and I mean, we're not talking about $200 million here. These are people that stole George Washington's China. I mean, these are the white trash of the white trash. They are the creme de la creme. They were brought into power by people that wore white pointy sheet head outfits. I mean, these people are jokes. We have, obviously, David Knight hosting the fourth hour today, Nightly News Tonight, 7 o'clock Central. This is a short segment, long segment, coming up here in a moment. I'm having trouble describing how crazy all this has gotten. I mean, again, the new WikiLeaks, the new DC leaks, Hillary selling access to the Chinese president. I didn't even think of that. She is so amoral, she's just selling to anybody. It's all massive felonies. And Dr. Jerome Corsi is an expert, not just on the banking, but on the federal laws. His new book, Partners in Crime, is now on sale at Amazon, you name it. Get it at bookstores. Very important, this book, go to the very, very top. We're going to talk about the book more in the next segment. But continuing, Dr. Corsi, and folks can also follow you there on Twitter. We've got that up on screen for TV viewers. You were interrupted by the break getting into the types of crimes they're committing, all these banking laws. I mean, I've talked to lawyers. If I set up some legal foreign shell corporation and try to put a little bit of money in there to avoid taxes, they'll probably come after me even though I'm following the law. It looks like the Clintons are just engaged in whatever they want. It's wild.
You're exactly right, Alex. And what they've done, the Clintons have also set up these shell corporations. They've got WJC, which is a Bill Clinton's initials, WJC LLC and WJC Investments. And both of these two companies function to just pass money through. You couldn't even tell where the money came from or where it's going, because these bank accounts are what money launderers and drug cartels, the Clintons are using the same vehicles for the Clinton Foundation.
They're using classic money laundering strategies.
Yes, classic. In fact, these would be immediately suspect under any banking laws.
Isn't this the red flag of red flags?
Yes, it absolutely is. You don't have a former president operating a shell corporation in the pass-through account. That's what money launderers do, what terrorists do. And then they've got money coming in through look-alike corporations. They have a Clinton Foundation in Canada. They've got a Clinton Foundation in Ireland. And often these are not even registered.
I mean, the
Clinton Foundation only got a determination letter initially to build the library. The Clinton Foundation decided that it was going to raise money for AIDS. It decided it was going to go into all these other structures. I can't see how the Clinton Global Initiative is a charity at all. You know, the money contributed to it, the philanthropy, gifts, and awards, these are very
rare.
So
here's the bottom line. It's one of the biggest criminal operations ever in our face. A, why do they think they can get away with it? B, will they? I mean, where does this go?
Well, I think, you know, I first got onto this with Charles Ortel, who's a good friend and one of the top financial analysts in New York on Wall Street. And Charles said to me, you've got to look at the audited financial statements filed with the Clinton Foundation, because they're absolutely fraudulent. You know, they list gross sums, the amount of money that came into the, they don't say where it came from. They don't account for the speeches. We have no idea where the speech money was paid for.
If you or I did this, we would be indicted within, what, 6 months?
Oh, sooner. I mean, this is so patently obvious. Money disappears. The money that the United Nations in Geneva says they give to the Clintons for AIDS is different every year than the amount of money the Clintons report. I mean, the financials don't even reconcile.
Why are they so arrogant? What does it show about their brains that they would do?
These are the kind of financials that a criminal files. These are the financials that you use to hide money. Just like a pass-through account is a giveaway that you're trying. That's how I caught, you know, I did the initial reporting on HSBC that it was money laundering.
As I said, your real rock star status isn't even politics people know you for. It's you're an expert in banking. You were the first guy to go after HSBC.
And by the way, Comey from the FBI worked as on the board of directors for HSBC.
Uh-huh.
These people are all tied together. Loretta Lynch gave HSBC, the attorney general, when she was in New York.
So they're clearly using it.
Yeah, they're clearly using the techniques. These are money laundering. That's the whole point of Partners in Crime. You've got to look at this as a criminal enterprise, money laundering, drug.
No, I understand you're documenting it's a fraud. We know that. You've done a great job. The should read the book, but we're going to break. We're going to come back and give you the floor. But the psychology, Dr. Corsi, why do they think they can get away with it? Is it because they think they're invincible?
They think they're smarter than everybody else and that they have the political power to push everyone off and they'll never be investigated. They'll never be prosecuted. Criminals always think they'll never get caught. They're the smartest.
So it's the criminology. It's the arrogance of a criminal.
Absolutely. And they get away with it, which is what we've got to put an end to.
Absolutely. I don't want this woman having the nuclear buttons when she's so damn arrogant. I mean, these people, folks, if you study criminology, of course he went right to the heart of it. I've only read, you know, 7 or 8 books on it, but it's like criminals love to get wilder and wilder, and they love to do all this stuff to try to get caught. We don't need this woman running the country. We're going to come back, go through the book. I've got a lot of key questions. Your phone calls, get it. Partners in Crime, available everywhere by Dr. Jerome Corsi. Dr. Jerome Corsi is our guest. There'll be a jam-packed fourth hour, obviously, with David Knight today. Got a lot of news I want to cover with Dr. Corsi and some phone calls I want to take, obviously, with your questions for him. He's got the new book out, Partners in Crime. We're going to go right back to him in a moment. But, I mean, I run a business that deals with credit cards and companies. And, man, we've had all sorts of stuff going on over the years with the feds and investigations and banks and proving stuff. Like, if we have some big sale of a new film, there's a bunch of money in the account, I got to go in and do all this stuff, and people actually come out and look at the DVDs and know it's real. And then, meanwhile, I watch the Clintons with billions of dollars just do whatever they want. I'm very offended. I mean, talk about discrimination. These people do whatever they want, whenever they want. It's crazy. We're going to talk about that in a moment. I've got a whole list of questions I want to go over with Dr. Corsi. Before I go any further, you can see that InfoWars, along with WorldNet Daily and Drudge and other great patriots, are telling the truth. I mean, the Soros emails coming out are word for word what we've said. Because quite frankly, they say this stuff in public too. But it's almost like, oh, it's a leak, so it's even more special. People actually pay attention to the leaks instead of Soros' own statements. It's very frustrating. But I'm glad that these emails, people are actually looking at them, because they basically just repeat what this monster has said. We need your support more than ever. We need you to send out the videos, the articles. That's how we're having this big effect. We're in a total war. You're in a total war. And we've got the new BioTruth Selenium that's from the mustard seed. It's organically extracted. It's in a cold process, so it doesn't lose. It's bioavailable. It's bioavailability. We believe from the research and Dr. Grip's research, this is the very best selenium out there. It's involved in all your major electrochemical processes in the body. It goes incredibly well with iodine and vitamin C, obviously, synergistically. If you don't have selenium, you die. And there's all the big studies. Go look at them about what selenium does to lifespan and fertility and everything. It's such a missing link. It's available at InfoWarsLife.com. It's our first run. It's selling out very, very quickly, and your purchases make the broadcast possible. We also have Hillary for Prison shirts that I normally sell for $19.95 that are best sellers. We've sold 100,000 of them. And then Hillary came out and said, I have this dark heart. I'm evil. I'm bad. I said, that's it. It's dark heart special, $9.95, including shipping. Shipping's $5. The T-shirt costs us like $5. This is at cost. Hillary for prison, delivered to your door. Give them to friends. Give them to family. This creates solidarity. It creates a meme. They hate this. Now, I'd like to say it supports the broadcast, but it doesn't because it's at cost. But when you buy Supermel Vitality or the Lung Cleanse or our Vitamin Mineral Fusion, Fruit Punch Multivitamin that's so organic, so great for your family, it funds our operation. Thank you for your support. InfoWarsLife.com is the nutraceuticals or the supplements. InfoWarsStore.com is the umbrella site that has everything from water filtration to documentaries and T-shirts, you name it, books. And, of course, you can also call toll-free 888-253-3139. Okay, Dr. Jerome Corsi's our guest. I want to go to calls in about 10 minutes. I've got a few questions I want to ask. But, sir, you've been polite pausing for me to customarily interrupt. I get so excited, like a little dog jumping up and down, you know, on the trail here. But other key points, Dr. Corsi, that people should be made aware of and that your book basically breaks down.
Well, I point out how the not only is the accounting fraudulent, which it tremendously is, there's no detail. You can't figure out where the money came in. The speeches are not accounted for. But also the idea the Clinton Foundation is doing good works needs to be attacked, because I point out that in some of these programs, fewer than 10% of the money goes to the charity that, for which it was given.
So that's another scandal. I saw the headline, 97%, even mainstream media admitted last week. And you're saying it's worse. The money, she puts it out of one pocket into the other. So that's a whole nother scandal.
Right. And it afforded, meanwhile, the Clintons are flying around in private airplanes there, living in five-star hotels paid for by the foundation. What you've got is a complete scam. I point out, you know, the drugs that were delivered, the HIV drugs delivered to Africa, were fraudulent. They were purchased from a company in India that made discount drugs, and they were defective.
Unbelievable.
The delivery system, there's an office in the warehouse district in South Boston that runs the Clinton Health Initiative. I went to that office. There's no sign on the outside of the building. You can't find out how many people work there. None of the financial reports detail what those people do, who they are, how
many. So let's be clear. They're giving 1, 2, 3% of the money to charity, and even when they do that, it's BS.
Right. And, you know, to find out who worked in this office that runs the biggest program, the Clinton Health Initiative, the largest program, this little office in South Boston, I had to interview the guy who delivers soda to the office. He's the only one who would talk to me. There's the only sign on the door. He says, well, there's some 20 people up there working or whatever. He didn't know what they did. You know, you know how much soda they drank. That's the problem. There's no reporting. The money in Haiti that was stolen by the Clintons. Federal reports, I cite some of this investigative reports after the Haiti disaster. Fewer than pennies on the dollar went to the Haiti people. The money was stolen by the Clintons. It was stolen by Beltway organizations with ties to the Clintons. It's been a big scam. This is why people need to file criminal complaints with their state attorneys general. As I point out in Partners in Crime, you've got money being solicited by these Clinton criminals to say, we're going to stop, you know, earthquake victims, we're going to help in Haiti, earthquake victims in India, AIDS in Africa. No, that's all just playing on misery. That's all using your sympathy to steal your money from you in a classic money laundering scheme where it's shell game. You'll never.
So I go back to square one, and the book breaks it down, Partners in Crime. This is like a million times what Nixon did. Why are they so emboldened? All these emails of Soros saying, have the UN take over the internet, shut down conservatives, arrest everybody, have the UN run our police. I mean, this is worse than I ever thought it was. These people are nuts.
Alex, I went into the Soros documents, and so I found that Soros funded a group, an African-American advocacy group called Color a Change. And they ran a campaign against the advertisers that succeeded in getting Glenn Beck off Fox and in getting Pat Buchanan off MSNBC. And the Soros documents brag about this. Alex, if your show had been on a cable network, Soros would have launched a campaign against your advertisers.
That's why we self-fund, absolutely. We even have them go after our suppliers. That's, I tell you what's scary about this is they've got so much HUMET. I know you've dealt in intelligence stuff that they like know all sorts of stuff and even go after suppliers that aren't even listed. I mean, they are literally up my you know what.
And they will, you know, continue to be with the IRS, with the banking officials. All the investigations you get are not by accident.
Oh, I know.
What the Soros documents prove is they brag about this in their internal board meetings and when they're funding.
Well, let's talk about Fox. I mean, I was told by Fox executives that I met with the Waldorf Astoria in Cleveland that already knew this. They said, no, you're absolutely right. There's a coup, made up Roger Ailes stuff. Okay, hugged a girl, whatever. The point is, this was the takeover in case they steal the election. They don't want Fox there to call it the other way. Fox isn't perfect, but they're taking it down, folks, because it's better than CNN, obviously. And it's just a bellwether of where we are that Media Matters 3 years ago in Politico said, run by the White House, we're going to infiltrate Fox and take it down. They did it. I mean, that is so outrageous. Dr. Corsi.
Well, they're, and again, going against your advertisers, getting the regulators to look at your taxes, to look at your bank accounts. I mean, what Partners in Crime is all about is that the Clintons have figured out a way to run a foundation where they steal the money. And they know that they control the IRS. They know they control the banking organizations. They control the Department of Justice. So they'll never be investigated. While they, you know, this is the global elite stealing the resources it needs to perpetuate their privilege and their...
I agree. So in a football game, with every major globalist foundation and every publication saying we're in red level emergency, our plan for world government's falling apart, I think it was like what Wall Street Journal today and Washington Post were just saying, we're dead. You know, American-driven globalism is over. Well, it's not American-driven. It's globalist hijacking us, using us. Are they playing possum, or are they really in this much trouble?
Well, what they're worried about is people are catching on. The American public is realizing that the economy has been stagnant. The middle class is losing their homes. They're losing their jobs. We've got 94 million people in America that are considered useless by the left. The African Americans have been abused for decades.
Let's be clear. The left makes people dependent and then talks crap about them all day how they're worthless.
Yeah, because they're worthless. They have, you know, all that Hillary Clinton wants is African American votes. All she wants is Latino votes. Obama's done nothing for the African Americans in this country. You know, the crime rates, the rates of
unemployment's doubled.
You know, the poverty. Blacks. Look at Detroit. I mean, you want every major city in the United States to be Detroit. And you have the United States as a whole move towards Detroit, and then put Hillary Clinton in office.
So let me ask you this, Dr. Corsi, the new book, Partners in Crime. How do they strike back, obviously? What do you expect in the next 69 days today till the election, November 8th? What do you expect to happen? What do you think about the polls? Obviously, internal polling shows Trump ahead in most polls. Even the LA Times admits he's a point ahead. They do these fake polls where they do 15% more Democrats than Republicans and Reuters and then say, oh, my gosh, he's got a 12-point lead. That's a 3-point deficit. I mean, looking into your tea leaves in like a 2 or 3 minute synopsis as a, you know, general of these wars, General Kenobi, what do you expect them to do next?
Well, there's going to be some unexpected wars. There's going to be another terrorist attack. There's going to be possibly even an assassination attack.
So they're going to October surprise either. False flags.
Yeah, false flags and, you know, manipulating the news.
Could they activate their jihadi forces they brought in?
They could. I mean, we could have that. And we could also have, you know, more diversions like this Huma Abedin thing with Wiener. I mean, who cares? You know, but again, it's sympathy for Huma Abedin. Stories about sex. The Democrats know that they'll survive sexual scandals. They think they will. You know, I think some of the rape stories that Roger Stone has brought forth in his book are very, very damning to the Clintons. But there's going to be a false flag manipulation of the news. And I caution, you know, the Trump organization and the Secret Service to be especially vigilant with both candidates. We don't need any political violence in the remainder of this campaign. It would be extremely detrimental to our cause of freedom because the globalists would just use it as another attempt to grab power. That's what's going to happen. Also, fear tactics. You're going to have, you know, the Clinton people trying to put Donald Trump as a madman, trying to say he's going to take this away from you. He's going to take that away from you. Don't listen to it. Donald Trump is the last real hope we have to preserve any freedom in this country. And the possibility of losing the First Amendment, the Second Amendment, the Fourth Amendment, you go on with Hillary Clinton is real. There will be no religious freedom. There'll be no gun freedom, no Second Amendment. These are serious, serious.
And by the way, they've always denied they want our guns. I've seen the Washington Post, Rolling Stone, all of them. They go, yeah, we're going to ban every gun and take them from you. And they'll even add stuff like, your kids belong to us, by the way. There's this sickening arrogance and this wild-eyed authoritarianism, even to the street-level minions of these people.
With the Soroses doing the intellectual propaganda disinformation techniques of saying, no, they're not Muslim terrorists who are unvetted. They're refugees. They have to be under the UN law. This is propaganda. This is disinformation constantly done. You know, it's the police who Black Lives Matter. The police are racist. Police are doing their jobs by and large. Throughout America, African-American communities depend on the police. You know, Hillary
and the cops pulling back is what's caused 1,000-plus black people to be shot this year in Chicago. I mean, look, the fact is, statistically, a couple hundred black people get shot by cops a year. It's totally made up. And I'm not even defending police, but you're absolutely right. It's that it's a total George Soros-funded red herring. When the average cop has a nightmare job, they want them to quit their job and put a social justice warrior in that position.
While behind the scenes, the Soroses and the Clintons steal billions of dollars from which they fund this leftist agenda. And it's not even a leftist agenda. They'll abandon the left as soon as they get power in the globalists. This is about the fact that, you know, 94 million people to the extreme globalists are worthless. They're not needed.
Absolutely. So let me ask you this, because you're one of the top experts. I'm not kissing your rear end. It's true. Dr. Jerome Corsi, the new book, Partners in Crime, worldnetdaily.com. You were one of the top experts. He really tells it like it is. Historically, looking at this situation, what do you think our chances are? Because I see a lot of positive things, I see a lot of negative things, and I'm constantly thinking, my God, it's worse than we thought. I mean, what can we do? Where are we? What's our position right now?
And we have to keep fighting. We have to keep bringing the truth out. We have to tell, reporting every day is, you know, we're doing. Get these stories out there, document them. American people are waking up. Donald Trump, I've known for 40 years, he always looks like he's losing and then he wins. He's a tomcat. He fights. But he, you know, and the press hates him. They're constantly against him. He's constantly threatening.
Because he is a loner. I mean, he's done the whole thing his own way before in business.
And done tremendous things for New York. I mean, look at the, going back to the Commodore Hotel, which is now the Grand Hotel. You know, the Javits Center built on land, he got it.
He loves to take old crappy things and make them beautiful.
He's done tremendous things for New York. He'll do tremendous things.
He will go to Detroit and rebuild it. These people,
And they're afraid because he'll rebuild it in a way that will bring back jobs, will bring back people. Trump cares about people. I've seen it in his employees. I've seen it in the people who live in his projects. I've seen it in people who work for him. Well, I know a great number of them love Donald Trump because he does care about people. You're not going to find anybody who really, you know, loves Hillary Clinton except George Soros. Her rallies are going to have 250 people to it. The only people supporting her are the globalists who want to, you know, contain this elite power structure over the news, filtering, oh, you can't be told this story.
Nothing. Well, sure, sure. What about the fact that he was here in Austin and they had 20,000 people in the deal? Our reporters were there 3 hours early, had to park 2.5 miles away and walk in. And Texas Monthly said he didn't have big crowds and it wasn't capacity you'd think it was. I tried, even though I had passes to get in, I couldn't get in. And I was invited backstage because it was miles of traffic. I got there 2 hours before. And then Texas Monthly lie. I mean, Texas Monthly didn't usually do that. Texas Monthly's written fair pieces on me. It's like they're all in, Dr. Corsi. They said that Trump didn't have big crowds in Texas.
And they're going to demonize everybody. They're going to do the propaganda and disinformation.
But that's what I'm saying. How are they so lockstep? How are they getting the media that was always horrible to be 10 times more deceptive?
The media is in the bag for them. Partisan media in the bag for them, and they're circulating.
But it was capacity, doctor. 2.5 mile lines, and they said that no one was there.
Read Politico. Read any of the groups that are really in the bag. You know, these daily newsletters they send out. They've got the themes. They've got the structure. They're communicating as they did in all these news nets, email.
Oh yeah, we had media call in. That's what they said. They said they all coordinate with each other.
Coordinate. So you come out. Okay, Hillary Clinton. Obvious health problems, medications that are, you know, old medication, post-concussion syndrome. You're going to see, I think, the potential for falling down or get confused and not be able to answer. Mainstream media says, no, nothing to see here. It's only a white right-wing conspiracy. No, she's got serious health problems. Even Obama's
You saw the Secret Service guy, he runs up and says, it's okay, and he has the pen, the doctor.
Yes,
and she looks completely insane.
Yeah, I mean, and you can see her losing it. You know, these little seizures Hillary's having, the falling down. These are serious issues, and the mainstream media is covering it up, just like they are the Clinton Foundation. But I think the facade is cracking. You see the New York Times saying the Clintons have got to close down the Clinton Foundation. That won't solve
anything. I agree. I'm even seeing like the Washington Post, out of this sea of lies, the Washington Post goes, Hillary really should have stood up for the gay people. Trump did. She lost an opportunity. Then we go to the gay pride parade. They're all, we hate him. He wants to kill us. I mean, it's just crazy.
Hillary saying that Donald Trump, you know, disabused a Gold Star parent. When Hillary Trump came back, in Benghazi, we had the bodies coming back from Benghazi of our ambassador, the others who died there. And Hillary's saying it was caused by a movie. She's lying to their parents.
She says, what difference does it make?
What difference does it make? We've got Bill Clinton abusing women and Hillary abusing their victims.
Her first court case was defending a guy she knew was a rapist of a seven-year-old. I mean,
yeah, Paula Jones, that he paid $800,000+ to settle a rape case with. And yet, you know, Hillary says she's for women. How can Hillary?
I got to be honest with you. It's crazy. It's like they say he's flip-flopped on immigration. He always said it's too hard to be legal. We're going to make it easier to be legal. But if you're a felon, we're kicking you out. We got a lot of bad folks coming in from Mexico, criminals. And then they turn into all Mexicans are criminals. And now they say it's a flip-flop when all he's doing is repeating what he always said.
Yeah, but except, you know, Donald Trump is brilliant. He's always been able to get the unearned media. He's very tough for these people to get. Because Donald Trump's used to New York. He's used to the media abuse.
And unearned means he doesn't pay for it.
And that's right. And the final analysis, everybody's talking about Trump, and they will to the end. And if they're all talking about Donald Trump right to the end, it's his agenda. He's going to win. And it's going to be massive, because I think you're going to find, just like in the Brexit vote, they're going to tell you, oh, don't vote. Hillary's going to win. It's all useless.
It's all done.
It's all done.
Donald Trump's dropping out next week.
Yeah, and the truth is, they're scared to death because they see what's going to happen starting in the next 2 months, and that is people are going to wake up and they're going to start paying attention, and they're going to say Donald Trump is the real deal.
Well, the algorithms show that. I mean, if people want anti-establishment, he said, I want to take a few phone calls. The book, Partners in Crime, available. Where's the best place, Dr. Corsi, for people to get this?
Thanks. It's available at all the bookstores. It's available at barnesandnoble.com, amazon.com. WND Superstore has copies that are signed. It's available everywhere, and thank you. I very much appreciate it.
Hey, we're all in the same war together, brother. God bless you. Let's take a few calls here. Alex is calling in from Mexico. Trump's set to meet in the next 30 minutes with the Mexican president, which I think is a great move. Just like going to New Orleans was when Hillary wasn't. Alex in Mexico, you're on the air with Dr. Jerome Corsi. Go ahead.
Hello, guys. Good afternoon. Well, first, let me say really quick that Soros-owned Mexican media is going absolutely nuts, and they're accusing the Mexican president of helping Donald Trump. So I would have to ask you, why would the Mexican government invite Donald Trump?
I was about to say, Fox says you're not welcome here because he's a globalist selling Mexico out. Mexico's always been better than other Latin American countries about not selling its sovereignty. Under the NAU, it ends. And that's what I would be. I was Trump, I'd tell the Mexican people, hey, my country's mine, yours is yours. We can work together, but we're being conquered by globalists. That's a great point, Dr. Corsi. Why did the Mexican president say 2 weeks ago, I would meet with Trump, and now Trump ran down there in a very honorable, respectful way?
Well, I suspect that we better have double the security when Trump is down there.
Oh, they admit the cartels are coming after him.
And secondly, I think that, you know, Donald Trump, the Mexican government may think they can embarrass Trump or that they can pull some stunt that will make Trump look bad. And I'm sure the New York Times, which, by the way, is owned by Carlos Slim.
Who runs Mexico.
Carlos Slim is in business with Soros. He's in business with the Clinton Foundation.
Sure, but I mean, maybe they are Trump, but maybe they're hedging their bets because they know he's the guy.
No, I don't. I think the main plan is to embarrass Trump and make him mad, have a narrative come out of this that they can.
Oh, like he was hated in Mexico. Look at this pathetic pig. But everybody sees the courage to go down there.
Well, and I think that's what.
He's walking into a trap.
Trump is communicating beyond the media. That's what scares the media so much. The New York Times knows it's losing its impact. The Wall Street Journal even is losing
its impact. And that's why they're so scared of him. I was asking, why are they so scared of Trump? I've never seen anyone they're 50 times more scared of him than anybody I've ever seen.
Well, they've almost won. They got you know, Glenn Beck. Soros paid to get Glenn Beck, attack the advertisers, get him off.
Sure, Beck rolled over.
Pat Buchanan. I mean, the list goes on and on. They've gotten the conservatives.
Oh, they've told me if I don't roll over, it's over. And I just said, pull the trigger.
Fox. You know, I haven't done a single thing, not one interview with this book on Fox. Fox is boycotting.
No, I know. That's how you know we're 2 minutes to midnight. They are shutting everything down, my friend. It's great to be here at the end with you, being honorable, isn't it?
Well, you know, look, Eric, I think, Alex, we're going to win. Because I just can't believe that, you know, this great nation is going to roll over and let these globalists steal our freedoms and enslave us. Fundamentally, the American people, I think, are out there and waking up. They're looking around. They're realizing they can't, you know, they're paycheck to paycheck and don't even know they're going to keep
their
house.
Well, exactly. And look how presidential Trump is. I mean, this guy is, I got to say, he's amazing.
Well, and Trump is seriously he has created jobs. Latinos look, African Americans look. Trump has employed more African Americans and more Latinos. He's done more for the minorities this
country. Yeah, that's why Jesse Jackson gave him that award 20 years ago.
That all the Democratic candidates put together. Hillary doesn't employ, you know, African Americans. She's not deploying Hispanics. Hillary.
Absolutely. Alex, have a quick comeback from Mexico with Dr. Corsi. Go ahead, quick comeback.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I was thinking the Mexican government maybe sees the things for which they are, and they're not seeing Mr. Trump going second in the polls, and that is why maybe they invited him, because they see Hillary going down in the polls.
That's what I think, but Corsi usually has the inside baseball. This president has criticized him, but maybe he realizes what's going on. I mean, look, sovereignty's the way to go. Our countries aren't perfect, but you go with globalists, they will exploit you, they will screw you over. Thank you, Alex. I'm going to come back and take a few final calls from John in Mexico and JT Coat, others. Dr. Corsi's got to go. Partners in Crime. We got 60 seconds left for you to finish, sir. Go ahead.
Well, it's just been a great pleasure and honor to be with you again. I think the whole purpose of Partners in Crime and the Clinton Foundation is to expose that these people are criminals, and that the Soros gang, the Clinton gang, even the mainstream media, you know, will go to any length to antagonize sponsors, to keep suppress the truth, keep a conservative message out. They don't want the First Amendment. They don't want the Second Amendment.
That's right. They're coming after our funding, so everybody fund us. Get the book. Buy stuff at InfoWarsStore.com. Spread the word. It's how you win the war in 21st century warfare. Thank you, Dr. Corsi. Globalists are going to find out when they finally engage the American people. The bullet's going to hit the bone. You're going to take all of our restraint as weakness, our kindness for weakness. We were just trying to give you a fair shot before we tear your arms out of your sockets politically. The real predator doesn't attack its own species. It has a governor. And you little pissant globalists don't have one of those. But history always offers up dumbasses that think they can set up their tyrannies. And when hundreds of millions of people are gone and dead, you'll be part of the ash heap of history. Now, that's down one possible route. I hope we don't go that way. But I'm committed. I know you are beaten. I'll tell you what's scary, though. They've been really arrogant up until now, and that's why we've been really having an effect. They've just now figured they put their arm in a wood chipper. They just now aren't being as arrogant. So they got some smart people. We're going to have some stuff to deal with. Don't make any mistake, but they're done. We've already got big blows in. We've already stabbed them a couple times. They may get us. We got children. The globalists don't have cultural children, spiritual children. They don't have progeny. They're not into life. They've got one life. That's why they don't want to lay it down. They want other people to lay it down. No, you're going to have to lay your life down for this. And so are we. But you see, escape is not our plan. You finally figured that out, didn't you? When you threatened us. Oh, you threatened us. Oh, my God, don't come get us. We don't want to make it easy for you, but we'll do anything to stand against you. Metaphysically, though, you're going to have to give ounce for ounce, pint for pint, gallon for gallon, as much blood as we do. And we're ready to give the blood, just like we've given the energy and the time and the focus. Look how weak you are. Look how lazy you are. Look at you. Look at what you are. That's why you're preparing this hell for all of us, because you're preparing your own kingdom that you will inherit, not us. John in Mexico, a lot of calls from Mexico. I should have thought of that. We should get calls from Mexico tomorrow. A lot of Mexican listeners, they had the flu down there and all that. Phones were loaded, great intel. Go ahead, John in Mexico. What's your view on all this?
Hello. Hi, Alex. Thank you for everything you and your team do exposing corruption. My question is, how could a country like Mexico, which is a crown jewel in the New World Order, free itself from globalist control? You're talking about a country that is already run by the international megabanks, where there is no Second Amendment, and where the ex-minister of finance of Carlos Salinas is currently the head of the OECD.
Absolutely. Mexico. Look, here's the deal. Mexico has more oil and more resources than the entire United States, one of the richest areas in the world other than some areas of Africa. Africa's per capita, per square inch, is more than anybody else, but of course, they're the poorest. It's just like it's metaphysical. And then the crazy, evil Middle East gets all the money. I mean, it's just, it's really twisted. But stay there. I'm going to come right back to you because you mentioned this. Exactly. Mexico heads up the OECD that runs the whole deal. And it's because Mexico has more billionaires per capita than the other country in the world because it's got its people enslaved. And Mexico was starting to struggle out of that 10 years ago, so they started the big drug war down there. So the globalists target countries that have the potential for strength. People can make jokes and say, Mexico, potential for strength? Absolutely it does. It has nationalism, and they're not cowards. We'll be back. I want to get a brief preview of what David Knight, chomping a bit to take over, has got to cover. I'll hit a few more calls. But everybody knows 10 years ago, they'd say, this show's depressing. You're talking about how we're way behind. All this horrible stuff's happening. I was telling people the truth about what was happening so we'd take action, not to demoralize you. Now we're having victories, and it doesn't mean the tide won't turn again, but this is the type of wargaming and real-life action that changes the world. And I'm not saying this to be cliched or to be virtue signaling when somebody calls in from Mexico, but I'll tell you, it is a paradox that I talk to people from Mexico, and when we take calls from Mexico, they're probably, on average, the most informed people that I talked to. And then look at how Mexico's a hellhole. Well, that's what you get when you're next door to the New World Order. The U.S. has been captured. Mexico has this colonial history, but it's also got people that'll fight. Mexico, for a long time, wouldn't let multinationals take it over until the 80s. That's now happened. And so it's just all part of the same exploitation. They don't want to merge us with Mexico to empower Mexico or merge us with Canada. They want to merge us to create a new political system where we're all enslaved. And so the caller brings up how Mexico is heavily involved in global government. But I'd say it's really weird, actually. Per capita, Mexico, when it gets to the New World Order, for its population of only 150 million, 130 million, is one of the most powerful groups in the New World Order. And I've tried to figure it out. I guess it's the money laundering, the drugs, the system they've got of feudalism. I don't know. Let me ask the caller, then I'll go to David Knight. You guys are typing something on screen, too. It says Mexico independence, or what are you saying? Oh, yes, it says September 16th, yeah. John, I mean, you really brought up a lot of points the average caller would know, that I was mentioning the world government body earlier that nobody even knows the name of. You're pointing out Mexico's at the heart of that. So what do you think's going on? What do you think's happening?
Well, I'm a trained attorney, and those of us who have time to worry about Mexico becoming a full-fledged colony again are few. Mexico usually ranks between the 13th and 15th economy in the world, but now has more billionaires than a few Western European countries, and little of this has worked for the interest of the vast majority of the Mexican people, most of whom do not realize that they are slowly being turned into slaves of a group they have no role in.
That's right. Let's be clear. The Mexican people are, per capita, Mexico for your population, has more billionaires than anybody else. So what does that say? Judge the tree by its fruit. Mexico is incredible. It has produced more wealth per capita than any place but South Africa. So, again, it's a paradox. What's going on?
Well, I think you just touched the nail on the head. I think it's the result of abuse and concentration of power. And also, there's a couple of things that I'd like to point out. There's education is incredibly poor, and the control of the media has been going on for generations. Just this morning, I made a post on a mainstream newspaper, and it was deleted within maybe 30 minutes. And it was pro-Trump, and it was anti-globalist, and this is the third time this has happened to me just this week in mainstream media in Mexico.
A few minutes more, sir. I mean, it's great to have you call in and break this down.
Yes, well, I guess sadly we're not surprised, for example, by the New York Times' unfair releases or Carlos Slim's influence thereof, nor sadly even by rigged elections or embezzlement of foundation monies. This has gone on for so long here, and there is such a distance between the powerful and the unpowerful here in Mexico, that it really is a uphill battle against globalism. So that's why I wanted to pose that question to you.
So is that it? I mean, give me your question, but Mexico, that's what I was thinking earlier, is the model of modern neo-feudalism. Is that it? Like the Mexican neo-colonialists working for the New York banks, they have been the most successful at squeezing the most out of their people.
I would definitely agree with that. However, I think a silent majority would agree with the Brexiters and with the nationalists. And I think
I want Mexico to be powerful. I want it to be wealthy. I want to have a great neighbor. Instead, it's just crazy how it's kept in poverty.
Well, I think part of the solution might be in James Pinkerton's article today in Breitbart, which is titled "Globalism Hits a Brick Wall." Now, what will Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton do? And I'll quote, the goal isn't socialism or anything like that. Instead, the goal is the widespread distribution of private property facilitated by conscious national economic development.
Can you imagine if they gave real free market to Mexico or Venezuela or anywhere? I mean, Venezuela was rich before they brought in socialism. They threw that out the door. Can you imagine if you gave real private property to Mexico, how wealthy that place would be in 20 years?
A lot of people joke here that Mexico is very close to God, very close, too close to the U.S., but very far from God.
Damn right. All right. Good to hear from you. Great points. We need people like that guy to like file videos and speak out, because that is so true. And it's sick. I mean, the wealth is unlimited, people, but you can't have kingpins, el jefes, running it. And look, the elite want to sew it up. They don't want you to have access to free market because they can't compete with it. David and I, we got loaded phone lines here. If you want to take them, that's great. I apologize if I don't get to them. I've got to go to a business meeting right now. I've got to leave right now. But epic things happening. I mean, you heard the show today where I talked about what we've known for a while, but it's really true. InfoWars is at the heart of the resistance. And we need to say that because we need your prayers and support. We're under sickening behind-the-scenes attack. If I told people, it's beyond a movie. I mean, it's been... God's taken me through it. It's been very painful, and you know, we've made it through it, and it's just another waves are coming, but it's still, I cannot believe the effect we're having. It is biblical, David Knight. I'm going to turn it over to you and leave right now. Go ahead, my friend.
Yeah, Alex, and of course, we continually see you being called out increasingly by people even up to the level of Hillary Clinton. They have ignored you for a while. You kind of, were very effective, but they didn't, as you pointed out earlier in the show, they would just refer to you as that guy in Texas, or they would say the dark corners of the internet or the vast right-wing conspiracy. Now they're calling you out by name. But you're talking about what was happening in Mexico and the kind of colonialism that we're seeing there. We're going to talk about what's happening here in America and a kind of colonialism of the connected and the billionaires, the kind of crony capitalism that we've seen operating throughout the third world, throughout Central and South America, throughout the Muslim world, throughout everywhere, essentially, except America. Now it is coming here. If you want to get successful in America, what you do is you get political patrons like the Clintons. And, of course, this all came home to roost yesterday, this report that was up on the Drudge Report from Breitbart showing Bill Clinton saying he's going to rebuild Detroit using Syrian refugees. And when I looked at that picture, I looked at this guy on the right who kind of looked like a profile of Groucho Marx from this particular picture. Guy doesn't look like it that much in other pictures. Talking to Clinton at the Clinton Global Initiative. And he was somebody that I didn't know. And I thought, who is this guy that is pushing so hard for refugee resettlement here in the United States? And why is he pushing that hard? There you can see the picture of him right there. Why is he pushing that hard? And as I started looking at it, I realized this is a story of unbelievable takeover of our country. It's not just refugees coming in and taking blue-class factory jobs or middle-class jobs with H-1B visas. No, they're coming in and they're taking over our entrepreneurship. They're taking over American businesses. They're taking that role and shutting us down using their connections in Washington. This guy's company, Chobani Yogurt, is a good example of this. And when you look at the small town, Twin Falls, Idaho, which, as you may not have connected the dots, was the place that we heard of back in June where you had that five-year-old girl who was raped by a group of juvenile refugees in that city. It was covered up by the media. It was covered up by the local government. And you say, why were they doing that? Eventually, the truth did come out. And yet, the reason for that is because you've got this guy coming in and putting in the world's largest yogurt factory in a very small town. And you've got massive applications of money going in to buy up the media there. Now, we're going to talk at the bottom of the hour to Lee Stranahan, who's been doing a series of investigative reports in Twin Falls, Idaho. He's going to give us eyewitness reports about what's been going on there. Of course, there's been a series of reports that have been ongoing. But one of the things that you have to understand, we talked about this on the Nightly News last night in a YouTube video that's up on Alex's channel, revealed foreign Fed member behind refugee push. This guy, who remains a Turkish citizen, actually sits on the board of the New York Fed. And of course, the New York Fed is the preeminent Federal Reserve Bank organization. There's 12 of them throughout the country, but they're the ones who have the preeminent position, the first among equals. They're the ones who make the calls. This guy, who started out with a massive influx of money from the Small Business Association, $800,000. Hey, you know what? I started a business with my wife. My father and both of my grandfathers had businesses. They never got a cent, never a cent from the federal government to start their businesses or to expand their businesses. Politically connected people like this foreign billionaire, Hamdi Yolukaya, are able to come in and get nearly $1 million to start their business. And then what did he do? He went out and he bought both New York senators and a large lobbying firm in Washington to get himself into the Michelle Obama school lunch program, where after a couple of years of liberally applied grease in the form of currency, he was able to get the school lunch program to say, hey, we're going to get rid of meat and we're going to start substituting his yogurt in the school lunch program. Isn't that nice? Isn't that nice? And so we're going to take a look at what's happening there. But before we go to that, he's going to be joining us at the bottom of the hour. When I look at this situation here of Homeland Security saying they're going to take over the elections, I knew when I saw this being put out there, hey, we got a couple of election boards that have been hacked, but don't worry, nothing has really happened. I told my wife when I saw that, I said, this is a false flag that is being set up. You know, we've had, of course, they can hack it. They've hacked all the federal employee personnel records. They've hacked the Federal Reserve notes, meeting notes, and they have actually hacked the NSA, stealing the NSA's hacking software and selling it on the internet. So, of course, they could hack anything they want. But the simple solution to this is to simply have paper ballots and people observing the election. That's the solution. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. Of course, this is August 31st, this is the day 271 since Hillary Clinton has had a press conference. Meanwhile, Donald Trump has had 16 press conferences. He's had about two press conferences a month. Hillary Clinton hasn't had one since last December before the first primary votes were held. Think about that. Think about the private, quiet, closed fundraisers that she has where the tickets are anywhere from $33,000 to $100,000 per person. And she speaks to small groups. You know, Nigel Farage said he's used to going at the grassroots level, going around to small, cold rooms where he's talking to 50 people at a time. You know, quite frankly, you see that all the time. Back in North Carolina, when I was involved in politics, even the big-name national politicians that would come through would speak to very, very small rooms. It's very unusual to see more than just a few dozen people in a room, even when a big-name politician with national status comes through. Donald Trump is speaking to football stadiums. Now, Hillary Clinton is speaking to small rooms, but small rooms so the people have a great deal of cash to give her. In the next segment, we're going to be talking to Breitbart reporter Lee Stranahan, And he's going to be talking about how this crony capitalism is manifesting itself in a very troubling way in Twin Falls, Idaho, the largest yogurt factory in the world. How did he get there? How did he build his business? It's a tale of crony capitalism. It's a tale of being connected to the Clintons. And so we're going to be talking to him in the next segment. Before we get back to the news, and I want to talk about what's happening in Brazil, because I think it truly is a harbinger of what we may be looking at here in this country. I want to point out to you that we've got a couple of specials. We've got 20% off vitamin mineral fusion drink. That's at InfoWarsLife.com. While supplies last, a very easy and tasteful way to get your supply of vitamins and minerals. It's much easier than taking a slew of pills. Tastes great, and you can get 1 month's supply out of that little container. Again, that's 20% off. Also, get your Hillary for Prison t-shirt at cost. You know, when Hillary called out Alex Jones and said he had a black heart, he said, okay, I'm going to run a black heart special. Hillary for Prison, InfoWarsStore.com. We're just going to double down, folks, because the truth is on our side. Just $9.95 to support the operation and take a stand against Hillary Clinton, to tell people that you know she is a corrupt criminal. And finally, our initial run of BioTruth Selenium is beginning to run low at InfoWarsLife.com. Take a look at that essential nutrient and the form that it's in. It's 100% organic. It's pressed from organic mustard seed. Very important source of an essential nutrient that you need in your life and your family's life. That is BioTruth Selenium. It is our initial entry, and it is beginning to run low. Now, what we have just learned is that the Brazilian president has just been ousted in an impeachment vote. This is on the Drudge Report. Washington Post says Brazil's Senate ousted Dilma Rousseff as president today, voting overwhelmingly to impeach her. The culmination of a protracted process, it was not even close. It was 61-20 to impeach her. And the reason I think this is very important for us is because I reported on this back when there was the GOP primary in Utah. The GOP in Utah paid $80,000 to bring in a voting machine company called Smartmatic. They are the biggest voting machine, electronic voting machine company in the world. And guess where this started, okay, and who started it? Smartmatic began in Venezuela with close ties to Hugo Chavez. Many people believe that they're responsible for his lock on the elections there, but there have been reports of corruption and rigged elections throughout Central and South America, including the Philippines and including Brazil. We looked at the Philippines and other places. In some cases, 25% of the votes were lost without any record to be able to backtrack that. So when we look at the fact that Homeland Security is saying, well, the electronic machines are hackable, of course they are. Everything is hackable. There's not any, even the NSA, as I pointed out, their hacking software was hacked. How's that for recursive programming? their hacking software was hacked and put on the internet for sale in their face. They've hacked the minutes of the Federal Reserve, as we pointed out. That is incredible insider information that can be exploited financially. So, of course, everything is hackable, but there is a very, very simple solution. And the U.S. government knows it. They did it when they had elections in Iraq. They would validate people. They would come in. They would have all the election on one day. You'd get your thumb painted purple so you couldn't vote a second time. You don't extend this out forever. North Carolina is one of the worst cases. Voting is going to start in just a few days in North Carolina. And in North Carolina, they have the longest voting period of anybody. And as I've said many times, my brother-in-law knows someone who went to the polling place because they don't require any photo ID. They said, you've already voted, and so has this other person at your address who was his dead mother. What we're going to have if we don't go back to honest, simple elections with paper ballots and human monitors is fraud. That's how she got in. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, and joining me in this segment is going to be Breitbart journalist. He's actually lead investigative reporter at Breitbart News. He's the founder of CitizenJournalistSchool.com, Lee Stranahan, and he's had a series of articles about what's going on in Twin Falls, Idaho. You say, well, why Twin Falls, Idaho? It's a very small town. It's got less than 50,000 people. Going back to August 10th, he had this story, Twin Falls Refugee Rape Special Report. Why are the refugees moving in the first place? He said, two recent sexual assaults by Muslims in this community of about 50,000 people have made national headlines and raised a wider question. Why are the refugees in Twin Falls there in the first place? Well, the answer to that is Chobani Yogurt, the world's largest yogurt factory, and the man behind it. And his story is an amazing story of how you can get ahead in the world today if you are a friend of the Clintons, if you buy influence with them. But, you know, as we look at this, and again, there was a lot of pushback when this story was originally reported of the first rape of the little girl, 5-year-old girl, who was raped by three other juveniles reportedly. And there was a lot of pushback. There was pushback in the mainstream media. There was pushback in the local media. There was pushback in the local government. We've got Slate calling the Drudge Report and InfoWars out. They said the Drudge Report trumpeted the InfoWars story with the headline, Syrian refugees rape little girl at knife point in Idaho. They say, oh, this is just a bunch of unsubstantiated rumors. I had the mayor there attack the family on Facebook. Well, the truth will eventually come out. And one of the people who has been at the very epicenter of this, again, is lead investigative reporter for Breitbart News, Lee Stranahan. He's joining us on the line right now. Thank you for joining us, Lee.
Yeah, David, thanks very much for having me.
Give us an idea of why, you asked the question, why are the refugees in Twin Falls there in the first place? And you answer that in your story. Tell us why they're there in the first place.
Well, the short answer is cheap labor and local oligarchy. Let's be clear on what's going on here.
Yes.
And also, let's be clear that what's going on in Twin Falls is not unique to Twin Falls. This is really what's going on across the country and around the world, but it's going on across the country in the United States. What's interesting about Twin Falls is that I think it provides a real microcosm of the problem. This provides a real microcosm of the problem with globalism.
Yes.
And the impact that it has in areas from law and order to public health to jobs and wages, right, across the country. And so I've been embedded up here in Twin Falls for about a month now. I'm going to be up here another couple weeks. And really because I think it hits on so many important issues. And often when we talk about these things on a national or international level, I think it's, in a sense, too abstract for people. I mean, you can get it, right?
Yeah.
But when you see it at a ground level, the way things are working, in a town that is, you know, like you say, about 50,000 people, it really comes into very, very sharp focus what we're up against here with this combination of big institutions, business, government, media, and even religion, working on a local level. The same thing that we're seeing on a global level. So that's one of the things that's interesting. And they have a great activist community up here. One of the things about Twin Falls is they're actually doing something about it. People like my friend Julie DeWolf is up here. There's a group up here called We the People that have been really at the forefront and keeping this story alive. The sexual assault, the rape happened back on June 2nd.
Yes.
And was buried. And I didn't even, you know, I was covering the political conventions and so I didn't get to it till the beginning of August, and other people were doing a great job. The activist up here, but you know, a number of other writers, you guys were on it, and the thing I've been really blessed to be able to do is to spend the time to do a deep dive in it and really start to look into the issues. And boy, I'll tell you, one thing that's very clear is the citizens of Twin Falls, the regular people, not the activists, just people living their life, they realize that they're being starved for information. They realize that the local media is, the fix is in with that local media. So,
and let's talk about that. That's a massive influx of capital from Warren Buffett and Berkshire Hathaway. Yep. $11 million into this tiny town in order to buy the media, essentially. So I think it's one of the reasons, I'm a conspiracy theorist, of course, but, you know, when you have that kind of influence there, you can suppress these stories. And they did that with the rape of that little 5-year-old girl. And then, as you pointed out in your series of stories, because we've had the second rape happen in August, and that was the rape by a refugee who had been profiled as one of the shining examples of upstanding citizens that are being brought in, and he was profiled by this very same media, and then he turns around and allegedly rapes a 33-year-old mentally retarded lady.
Yeah, he molested her. Mm-hmm. He was planning to rape her, he said.
Okay.
But she fled.
And so that's an interesting part of the story, but I think it's also, as we look at this other story, what surfaced yesterday with Breitbart in Detroit, You've got Bill Clinton with the Clinton Foundation, the Clinton Global Initiative, and this guy who owns the yogurt factory there, that massive presence there, $450 million to start it, the world's largest yogurt factory. He's now expanding it with another $100 million, so this thing continues to grow. And he's bragging about how he's got 30% of his employees there are refugees. They speak 11 different languages. I told my wife, I said, you know, he says, I've got translators for these 11 different languages there 24/7. And I said, it would be a lot cheaper, wouldn't it, just to teach them English? But he wants these people to be captive to him, doesn't he?
That's by right. Keeping them to hire Americans. That's another wacky idea that I'd have.
Yeah.
Maybe, I don't know, maybe like the veterans I've interviewed who applied and couldn't get a job there.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
And if you think, let's think about that irony for just one second. We have these global interests who start wars like the war in Iraq, let's say. Let's use that as an example, okay? Mm-hmm. A war that was supported by both Bush and Clinton. Not to be a conspiracy theorist, but that's just a fact, right?
That's right.
Then the war creates a situation where you have refugees. Does that make sense? So they've started a war,
mm-hmm.
ruined the country.
Mm-hmm.
Now people want to flee the country. Then those people come to this country and take jobs that veterans of that war can't get.
Yeah.
think about that. And you're exactly right. The reason, it's not just wages, because the obvious thing is people go, well, they can pay them less or whatever. And that's, you know, true to some extent. They can, you know, they're not as likely to, you know, rise to the ranks and, you know, want more pay. They need to work. But the other big issue is control. And there's also the issue that there's financial incentives. There's a pamphlet that the local refugee center put out, and they tell you, I did a story on it. It's really amazing. It was a really easy story to write, David. I just did copy and paste from the brochure, and the brochure was literally saying things like, you know, if someone's from Afghanistan, be careful not to ask about their wife because they might seek revenge. That was the kind of thing they were saying in there. And they're telling employers, you know, don't look, if a person's from Eritrea, don't look them in the eye because they won't like that. Or don't, you know, all these things. And you'd think it would be easier just to say, hi, you're in America now.
Yeah.
Chill.
Yeah.
People are going to ask about your wife and look at you. And some people won't look at you. And some people won't ask about your wife and just chill. This is America. That's life. Get used to it. But instead, they have to tell the employers how to get used to it. And, you know, you mentioned the media here. The local newspaper, I got more interested in them when they did an editorial attacking Breitbart and me. As you may have noticed, Breitbart has come under some attacks for some reason the past couple weeks.
Exactly.
Ever since Steve Bannon took over the Trump campaign, Hillary Clinton's talked about us, and she loves you guys as well. So
it's a badge of honor, isn't family. It? It's a badge of honor, isn't it?
It sure is, yeah. But the local newspaper did an editorial that attacked me by name and attacked Breitbart. They said, well, I'm not a journalist, and I'm, you know, because I'm an activist. And I don't see any contradiction between being a, I'm if they want to label me that way, great. I'm an activist who's done better journalism than the local paper. Let me put it that way.
You know, Steve,
I'm not a journalist. If they want to call me that, that's fine.
You know, Lee, I think that we got to get rid of this idea that the mainstream media is perfectly objective. That is their main tool of deception, to say that they don't have an opinion. I would rather, and I have always gotten my news from people who are upfront about the fact that they have a point of view, that they have an opinion. If they don't understand what their bias is, then they're either ignorant or they're lying to you. Everybody has biases. Even the stories that you choose to support, to report, that is an indication of what you're interested in or what your bias is or what your point of view is. So I think
that's
whole
exactly
idea.
Right. I can watch Rachel Maddow, mm-hmm. and I know where she comes from. So I can use that filter or whatever, and she does a lot of very factual, she lays out facts a lot of the time. And I can
right.
go, okay, well, she's saying this, you know, Alex is saying that or whatever, and I can just compare and figure things out on my own, and I think most people can. What we learned about the local media is that they're owned by a company that was financed by Warren Buffett, head of Berkshire Hathaway, who's out on the stump for Hillary Clinton, right? We know that mm-hmm. Warren Buffett is out on the stump promoting Hillary Clinton. And the other thing that's very interesting around town is Berkshire Hathaway Realty is a major player here in town. You see them doing commercial real estate and local real estate. So this little economic boom that's been created by the globalist here, gee, Warren Buffett's kind of making some money off of that, you see?
Yeah.
And so the reason they're attacking me and Breitbart and you guys and anybody else reporting on this is real simple. We're bad for business, right? That's what mm-hmm. it is. They're concerned that us raising these issues or the local activist raising these issues is bad for business. Now, it's bad for their business, maybe, right? Because you got to remember, when the factory was put up, it's the world's largest yogurt factory here. It was put up with tens of millions of dollars, about $54 million in government incentives. So it wasn't like they just built it on their own.
Exactly.
This is like the Olympics where cities compete, right? They want the business. And so the city council here bent over backwards, or possibly a better analogy is they bent over forwards.
Yeah. Or bent over the taxpayer forward.
Exactly, yeah. Right. And yeah. And again, you know, it's the kind of thing we see all the time where big businesses, and I don't care whether it's Walmart, which is very American, they get all these incentives. And I'll tell you what happens. One of the things, this story in Twin Falls, a lot of it is about unintended consequences. So that girl got raped because they brought in refugees as cheap labor, which happened because they had economically wanted to get this yogurt factory here, and the guy who runs the yogurt factory is a major booster of the refugee program. And when I say booster, I mean working with the Clintons, working with Chuck Schumer, and working with Republicans like the Republican governor here, Butch Otter.
Yes, and going to Davos and telling, getting Davos, commitments. Yeah, well, he's set up a tent foundation to bring in refugees, saying they're the best. And that's what he was doing with Bill Clinton when they were talking about Detroit. They say, hey, we got all these empty homes. We can give them to the refugees.
Well, and
they're great employees.
Later, today or tomorrow on Breitbart, that goes into more detail about some of this stuff. Hamdi Ulukai, who is not, I just want to make this clear, he's not a U.S. citizen.
That's right.
That's fine, but let's be clear.
And yet he's on the New York Fed board. How does that happen?
Fed, yeah. Which I'm sure that doesn't, anyone who listens to the InfoWars, that doesn't mean anything. But, and he's working with John Podesta's group, with the Center for American Progress, doing a report that quotes the IMF, the International Monetary Fund. Again, that won't mean anything to listeners of InfoWars. But, I mean, I'm saying that facetiously, but here's the thing. The people who listen to you guys, the people who listen to Breitbart, they know who the IMF, the people who read Breitbart, they know who the IMF is. They know what the Fed is and what that means.
Mm-hmm.
Most people are busy with their lives and kids and jobs, right?
Yep.
So they don't know. If I say, well, they did a report with Podesta and the IMF, they don't understand the implication of that. The implication is these guys all work together. This is a group of people, guys and gals. Let's throw Hillary in there. They all work together, right? And they're all jetting off to Davos and doing Huffington Post editorials and everything else, working together. Meantime, like I say, you end up with this situation where we really wanted to do in Twin Falls was look into the causation and then the ripple effect that this has had throughout the city, and then show how that's worked in other places. Now, Hamdi Ulukai, not a U.S. citizen. In 2000, let me back up 1 second. So he became friends with Chuck Schumer because he's got another factory in New York.
That's where his first factory was, yeah.
Chuck Schumer urged him to be part of the federal school lunch program. And I'm gonna avoid getting details on that right now because I don't want to be confusing. But so Chuck Schumer buddies up to Hamdi Ulukai and vice versa because it's good for Hamdi's business and it's good for Chuck's political career now and for the constituents in New York. So what they do is, in 2013, when Chuck Schumer was part of the Gang of Eight pushing for open borders, guess who becomes a special guest and visits with President Obama in the White House to promote comprehensive immigration reform? That would be Hamdi Ulukai.
Yeah.
So think about that. We have a non-U.S. citizen, which is, again, that's fine, pushing for immigration reform in America when it's an issue that he's not a citizen.
Yeah.
Pushing for that. I would not expect to go to Australia and push for more immigration to Australia because I'm not Australian.
It's just mind-boggling. Yeah, exactly. How does he have the authority to go in and tell us that how many people we should bring into our country that aren't Americans? He's not even an American, and he's sitting on the Fed board where they're making economic policy. I mean, the New York Fed is the center of the Fed, and this guy is there, and he's a Turkish citizen.
And we have a story coming at Breitbart. My colleague, Michael Patrick Leahy, he's been great on this. Now, think about this. We contacted Chobani and asked them a simple question. We're just confirming that is he a U.S. citizen or not. Forbes reported, and I linked to it, Forbes reported he's not a U.S. citizen. Their response, now you'd think that's an easy question, right? No comment.
No comment. I bet they don't want any comment. Yeah, but he brags on his Tet Foundation that he is a member of the Federal Reserve Board of New York.
That's exactly
right.
Yeah,
he brags about that.
Here's what happens. The White House needs these dog and pony shows. You know, immigrants, businessmen, successful entrepreneurs also support comprehensive immigration reform. So he's out there. You can look this up. It's on C-SPAN. He makes a statement. Steve Case from AOL makes a statement. These other guys. And they come out. So what's in it for the government is they're little puppets in the dog and pony show. Oh, look, Hamdi Ulukai is a successful immigrant. He's a successful entrepreneur. Now, what they don't tell you is that part of his success is that Chuck Schumer, 2 weeks ago, this again, conspiracy theory, right? He goes to the White House. He makes the statement. 2 weeks later, the White House comes out and says, guess what? We'd like Greek yogurt, not any yogurt, Greek yogurt, which is what Chobani yogurt is.
Yeah.
To become part of the federal school lunch program.
And he basically owns the Greek yogurt segment. He's got more than 50%. Stay with us. We'll be right back with Lee Stranahan, Breitbart lead investigative reporter. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, and we're talking to Lee Stranahan, lead investigative reporter, Breitbart News, founder of CitizenJournalismSchool.com. He is in Twin Falls, Idaho, looking at what's happening with the refugee situation there. And, of course, the billionaire who is an advocate for bringing in refugees, as just pointed out. Here's a guy who is speaking at the UN, meeting with President Obama, telling us that we need to bring in more and more refugees, as we saw this article that was up yesterday on Breitbart. Bill Clinton meeting with Hamdi Ulukai, and he is saying, hey, let's fill Detroit with refugees. We've got 10,000 empty homes. Let's just bring these guys in. They're, you know, better than the people who are already there, black and white. And it's interesting, if you look at the proposals that Hillary Clinton has, she's proposing to bring in more than the current population of Detroit. In terms of just refugees alone, we don't have any way to vet who these people are. We go into the country, we start a war, and then we bring in the angry people into this country without being able to vet them, saying they're refugees. There's other ways to help them. One of the ways might be to stop the war we started. Before we go back to Lee and finish up, I want to tell you about a couple of specials that we have here at InfoWars. Of course, that's the way we support ourselves. It's the way that we keep ourselves independent of the kind of levers that they apply in terms of pressure to the mainstream media. We sell directly. We sell products that will help you, and that helps us to keep our operation going. Right now, we have a sale on Vitamin Mineral Fusion Drink Mix. That's at InfoWarsLife.com, 20% off. That's 1 month's supply of essential vitamins and minerals in a very easy-to-swallow liquid format. And also very tasty. Again, that's Vitamin Mineral Fusion Drink. It has all the essential vitamins and minerals that you're going to need for supplementation in an easy-to-swallow, tasteful drink. Also, we have discounted the Hillary for Prison T-shirts as part of our Black Heart Special. Take this, Hillary. We're going to give these things away at cost. You can get them at $9.95 at InfoWarsStore.com. This is a great way to send the message that you know exactly where Hillary belongs, the big house, not the White House. Let's go back to Lee Stranahan, who is in Twin Falls, Idaho, as you were talking about how easy it was for him to get not only yogurt in Michelle's school lunch program, but specifically the kind of yogurt that he sells, that he has a market dominance in. And, of course, he did that with just 8 months of lobbying, but with massive amounts of cash being spent in Washington. He started out his business with an $800,000 small business loan, and he put in $700,000 worth of lobbying through the Cornerstone government lobbying firm. And it got some pretty good results for him, didn't it, Lee?
Yeah, I mean, he's been doing, it's over 700,000 over years, over about 6 years now, when all this stuff started. And again, this can't be emphasized enough. You hit it. But Chuck Schumer, here's the thing. They're not subtle.
That's right.
About the puppet show. They're not subtle about it.
Mm-hmm.
But they know that most people won't even do one layer of research down. Does that make sense?
Yep.
Just most people are just, again, I get it. People are busy and they can't research everything. So they see the guy come out at the White House and they go, okay, well, it seems like a business guy is in favor of this comprehensive immigration form. They don't read The Hill, which is an Inside the Beltway publication. So they missed The Hill saying 2 weeks later, oh, by the way, the White House wants to push for Greek yogurt being part of the school lunch program. They don't read the local Albany paper that says, Chuck Schumer is doing this, promoting this.
We're running out of time, Lee. Tell people you're going to be there for a while. You're doing a whole series of investigations on what's going on with the refugee situation in Idaho. The fact that they are replacing Americans from the worker all the way up to the CEO. You're going to be there for a while. You're with Breitbart News. This is Lee Stranahan. Join us tonight, 7 Central, 8 p.m. Eastern, for the InfoWars Nightly News. Thank you so much, Lee.
You're awesome. Thanks very much.
Thank you.